Russ Martin Show.
Primary competitor for listeners is The Ticket, which is a great radio station that I have a lot of respect for.
I do. They're one of the top billers in the market.
Mm-hmm.
And they have some good programs.
Which ones?
I'm not going to go down.
Which shows do you enjoy on The Ticket?
Well, obviously they have decent ratings, so. Mm-hmm.
But theirs is older. You're talking about a younger male audience.
Yeah.
Theirs is like, what is it, 40 and up?
Yeah. They primarily cater to 40 to 50-year-old males. We're younger.
Right. Mm-hmm. So what shows do you enjoy on The Ticket?
I think they have some successful shows.
What are your favorites?
I'm not going to go into my favorites. I'm not like a fan in that. I just think they have a good there's nothing wrong with saying your competitor is a great radio station.
Well, of course not. It makes you look like a bigger shot because you're kicking their ass.
Yeah.
I mean, how great is it to go, hey, you know what? My competitor is a paraplegic. So that makes sense. Well, what are some of the shows you enjoy in the town?
Don't. I flip it on occasionally to monitor it, to listen to sports, stuff like that.
And what shows do you enjoy on The Ticket?
Mm-hmm.
I don't necessarily. I just listen.
Okay. Well, when you listen, what's on?
I think their morning show has a lot of talent.
Who is that?
George Dunham and Craig Miller.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I know them?
No.
All right. What's on middays over there?
Middays.
Don't act like you don't know.
Middays, they have Norm Hipskiss and a show called Bad Radio.
Hey, what a coincidence. What am I going to look like come October? What are we dancing? 14?
14.
All right. Is it going to be dramatically different?
Was that cake good?
Yeah. Why?
I just want to. Yeah, you look better.
Why do you ask me about the cake?
I didn't get any.
Well, there's still some in the fridge.
What's the big deal with the cake?
I don't know. What's the deal with the cake?
Why didn't you get some? How was the food?
It was fine. Did you not eat any?
Mm-mm.
Why not?
I was a little stressed.
About what?
The day. Maybe that's why your stomach hurt.
That you were stressed?
No, that you were stressed.
I was
stressed, too.
I wasn't stressed. You guys were doing everything. Rob went and got the... Where'd you get the food? What?
Nothing.
What am I missing?
I don't know.
I was there, and I don't know.
What the hell's going on?
I can't get it out of me.
And you guys were there.
Yeah. Tell us, God.
What happened?
I was just wondering how the cake was.
It was dandy.
Go home and get some.
Yeah. There's still a fridge full of it.
I don't think so. I saw the cake when I left. There was nothing left of it.
Yeah, there was plenty. Amy had some after everybody left.
Mm.
Why were you stressed about Saturday?
Where do you want me to start now?
Does that sound like me having an argument with a chick?
Yeah.
What was wrong with Saturday? Well, you know.
I have to tell you.
Yeah.
Obviously, we don't communicate very well.
I want your spit. Hi, Johnny. What do we have this week at the animal shelter?
We have a full house, as always. Lots of cute little dogs. And a special dog to mention is named simply Doggy Dog. He's a black lab.
Of course.
He's just a sweet, sweet-tempered dog. You know, he hasn't really been treated very well most of his life. So we'd like a really great home for him.
What are you doing to that dog in the background?
Well, I'm actually off today, and that's my Muffin, and she's playing with her squeaky toy.
Snoop Dogg is ready for adoption?
Oh, Doggy Dog.
Whatever.
He's on the website Doggy Dog. So, and you remember...
Is that another toy the dog has in the background?
Yes. Well,
a little harp?
Maybe that one's going to heaven.
Another...
dog just died? what'd you say? Line four? Hi, Eric.
Yeah.
Yes.
Russ?
Yes.
Yes, sir. I'm one of those football kids who did some real stupid stuff, and all we got was probation.
What did you do?
I did about, we busted into a log cabin house up in the hills and stole the man's gun, shot up his house, shot up his stuff, trophies that he hunted, and we pushed down about 12 deer stands down the side of the mountains and everything out in Mineral Wells.
How'd you get out?
What's that?
You know what? Even though that's a jacked up thing to do, it's still not like shoving a gun in somebody's face and taking their cash.
The guy was home.
Oh, he was?
Yes.
How'd you get out?
The back door.
Now, how did you get out of being a...
The Russ Martin Show.
Arguing in the hall, Gavin's telling me I'm using too much of the testosterone cream.
Okay.
It says 1 cc in the morning.
All right. What are you doing?
I'm just going from, it's in a like a needleless shrimp,
okay,
syringe.
All right.
Like a little plunger.
Mm-hmm.
It's got 10 units. I just go from like 10 to 9, 9 to 8.
If you're doing the right amount, then there shouldn't be a problem.
So you're doing 2 ounces a day?
CCs.
Two CCs?
One CC.
Okay.
What is it, Gavin?
Yeah, one CC is 10 to 9.
All right. So I was right.
All right.
What Gavin was telling me from 10 to 9 was 10 CCs.
No. No. Not those little syringes. I've seen those.
Well, this one's about the size of a magic marker.
Oh, yeah, that's a lot bigger than the ones I've seen before.
Yeah, that's about the size of that highlighter.
That's a 100cc syringe.
Oh.
Yeah, you are using 10.
10 times the amount you're supposed to. One number to the next one is 10cc?
Right. So you need to get a 10cc syringe.
I do love to work out.
Must be just a joy around your house.
We'll get. Gavin.
Yes.
So which is it? Is like from one number to one number, is that 1cc or 10?
It all depends on what size thing you have, but he said if it's a 10cc syringe looking thing, then it's 10 to 9.
I don't know if it's 10cc. All I know is it's this big. It's about the size of a highlighter.
It's going to be 10cc, yeah. That's going to be 10 times the dose that you're supposed to have.
Well, Gavin, call them back and tell them it's my prescription. They'll know what they put it in.
Okay.
Thank you.
Because the ones I did a long time ago, 1cc is barely enough to get your hand wet.
Yeah, I guess that would make sense.
Yes.
Because if I dump 10cc out of that syringe, mm-hmm, that'd be a wad on the counter, and I don't blow that much.
Exactly.
All right, well,
Pull it back, a spooch.
A spooch.
Well, it's even worse because a couple of days, when I first got the stuff, I went, you know, we'll give it a little kickstart.
Oh, no.
I'll do, here we go. I'll do 2 cc's to start with.
Oh, my God. So even does 20. Wow.
Well, it doesn't say on there how much a cc is. It just says 1 cc in the morning.
I believe they asked you when you checked out, do you have any questions regarding this medication?
They didn't ask me anything. They just gave me the bag and they went,
do you have any questions about this medication? Because I've bought medicine there before.
This is a refill, and they didn't. Normally, they ask you if it's your first go round with any med.
I'll bet you money on that syringe somewhere it says 100 cc's. Yeah, normally pretty clearly marked.
It doesn't. It just has the measurements 10 to 0. Wow.
Hold on.
Line 2. Yeah, Stacy.
Hey, Russ, a 10cc syringe is about the size of a highlighter. 100cc's is about a half of a Coca-Cola. So you should have a 10cc syringe.
Well, then maybe I'm doing it right.
Yeah, you're doing it right. JD's wrong.
All right, so something that I've got one of these little Sharpie accent highlighters in my hand, and that's about the size of that
right.
pump that I got. So from right. 10 to 9 is only 1cc.
Right.
Okay. Thank you, then.
You're very welcome.
That doesn't sound right, because no. If I were to dump, what's the average amount of male ejaculate? I know it's not 10 cc.
No, I know.
It's like 6, 7? Yes,
something like that in the middle.
I don't blow that much out.
No. We didn't ask what she does for a living, either. She'd be a dancer.
And again, an expert.
Yeah.
Yes, Gavin?
You received 3 10 cc syringes.
Okay. So each number is only 1cc.
That's what he told me, yes.
All right, then I'm fine.
Okay.
Well, I got...
That would be very bad if you'd taken 20 the first day.
Well, it's just a cream. I don't even know what the concentrate is on it.
2%?
I don't know. Did he say, Gavin?
No, he didn't say the percentage. He just looked up your account, and he said this is what we gave him, and he said as long as he goes from number to number, that'll be the proper amount.
Okay. All right, then I'm fine. Yeah, you're wrong, and you owe me some cash.
You can bet.
Well, yeah, he contends that my edginess has gone up because I'm taking too much.
Testosterone.
I'm following the instructions on this. Doesn't say anywhere that alcohol is going to affect it, so I'm still drinking.
You still taking the other?
The lorazepam?
Yeah.
I ran out.
Get on that again.
Trey, can you refill this?
Yeah, we'll get you some more.
Well, yeah, I mean, call somebody.
If you're going to OD on something, make it that.
Why?
Because you were a lot happier and more content when
I just ran out yesterday.
Oh, okay.
And Venegas didn't put any refills on there?
3 refills before 7:10:08. Booyah.
Give it to me, I'll call it in.
I'll get it on the way home. You have anything to hold me?
Oh, yes.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Drug dealers. Something to get up, something to get down.
Oh. What?
Oh, my system right now is just a chemistry experiment. Hydrocodone, Adderall, lorazepam.
Damn.
Now, the hydrocodone because of your back.
Yes.
Why don't you just have surgery? Can you do that?
It's not surgical.
Just replace the spine. Use Gavin's. His is low mileage.
Very nice.
Thank you. What? What's wrong with your back?
Just muscle spasms.
Is that from stress?
Part stress, part... pair of boots I was wearing needed to be resoled, so I was standing wrong, and it was putting a lot of pressure on the left side.
Why don't you get some earth shoes?
Some earth shoes?
Yeah.
What are those?
What are those?
It's about to show his age.
Huh?
It's a shoe that's designed specifically for the way you're supposed to walk versus most shoes that aren't. Like, that's why really good tennis shoes cost so much money.
Well, what do they call them now?
I'm not sure they still sell earth shoes.
Oh. We'll get you some nice orthopedics.
I'm fine, just getting my boots resoled. Not a big deal.
If you don't make Earth shoes?
I don't believe they do anymore, no. They make really nice work shoes for people in restaurants. They sell those at Walmart.
Oh, okay.
I believe that was from the 70s.
Earth shoes?
Well, I knew they're. I know they're from the 70s. I just don't know how long ago they quit selling them.
All right. Don't want to take any of those, Dan, before we get going?
Yeah, line two is about your cream.
Oh, all right. Yes, Tricia.
Hey.
Yes.
They say if you take that half that dose in the morning and half in the afternoon, you level out and be less crazy. You won't go peak and valley so much.
I just figured it'd be out of my system by the time I got here in the afternoon. I just wanted it right before the workout.
Yeah, no, if you take it like 12 hours in the morning and 12 hours later, half of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I've been doing the female end of it for years.
Taking hormones?
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you?
Oh, just old.
How old are you?
52.
What do the hormones do? Does that reverse some of the signs of maleness?
It takes down the hot flashes and all that other stuff. So.
You got a goat?
Hmm?
Stash?
Don't.
Sideburns.
Be nice to her. She hung up on you.
Isn't that normally why they take the hormones to reverse the signs of
menopause?
Well, that and just balance them out so you don't have peaks and valleys of craziness.
I wonder why nature does that to them, other than the obvious reason.
I couldn't tell you.
Just to be a chick. I mean, it pays off early because if you're hot, you get everything that you want to command will happen because you're hot and you got control of all the goods. But once you hit menopause, it's like nature is sitting around waiting on your dog ass. You wait till 50.
God won't want you to stop having kids. So he's going to make you as ugly as possible. He doesn't want to really kill you. He just wants to make you ugly.
Wants to let us know that they're not to waste our time depositing sperm in something whose eggs done gone bad.
And, you know, and angry and everything else we don't like about women. It just goes to the infinity.
I never thought about that. Now, I figured out why they'd start growing facial hair, because that's the easiest way for men to spot that you're no longer potent. And there's no reason for me to screw you.
That's true.
I got that, because nature grows things on hair that you don't supposed to eat.
Right.
But I didn't think about the other thing.
Chuck liked that one.
You never heard me say that? But it does. You open the fridge, if the cheese has got hair on it, you don't eat it. It's gone through its menopause.
Yeah, pretty much anything that has hair, I'd stay away from.
Same thing with chicks, but you're right, I didn't think about that. Menopause tends to make them as unappealing to us. That's why menopause makes, they start to look like guys.
Mm-hmm. Everything that we hate about them, but put up with, we no longer have to put up with.
What a rib. You gotta have periods forever. I mean, yeah, I'm gonna go through menopause. I lose my periods. Yeah, but you get a nice Fu Manchu.
Yeah, they do. That's, you're right. I never ever thought of that until you said it. And as funny as I thought it was when you said it as a bit, it really makes sense.
Well, because men are potent. We're potent until we're dead.
Yeah.
And because women go through a stage where they can no longer have children, and I guess nature does that because at a certain point it's dangerous. Mm-hmm. So it's like a protective mechanism. But nature doesn't want us to waste our sperm.
Makes sense. Just make it ugly and mean.
I hadn't really thought about it, but they really do get the raw end of the deal. Period, cramps, pregnancy.
Yeah, but they get all the good stuff in the beginning. There's the balance.
All right, go this way. Would you trade it out if from as soon as you hit your sexuality, let's say as soon as you hit puberty, or age of consent, in case anybody listening. As soon as you hit age of consent, until you hit menopause, is it really worth the trade-out of all the things that you get?
If you're
late 40s, 50s, everything's gone.
You're hot. You get a free ride from 18 to 50. But how many years is that? Man, I don't know. That's a tough one. I don't know if I'd swap out. No.
Because once you hit 50, there's nothing else to look forward to. No. You can take the hormones, and that'll reverse some of the signs of your masculinity. But
they have still a good life. You think they can still
travel?
Read? I don't know.
Check the internet? Look for fetish groups?
Yeah, you're right. That would suck. God, that would suck.
Some guy who can't decide if he's queer or not?
Yeah, we're going to go right
now.
Well,
I'll start with some chick who's past menopause and see if I like it. Dan, what?
Ask her not to shave.
What is line one?
Apparently, you were referenced in a golfing magazine, and he thought you should be aware of it because obviously you would never find out.
Well, it's finally time I've been recognized.
Golf magazine. You've made it.
I'm still stuck on the bisexual sleeping with chicks past menopause.
I'm just going to try it.
I wonder if they go through menopause if their bits bigger. Be like bumping heads.
Not really gay.
Yeah. No, because it's still a chick, so if anybody comes by, yeah. I just show them their driver's license.
Like, Dan, baby steps.
Yeah.
You don't want to go full size immediately. You'll start with that one.
Yeah, well, you don't want to sleep with a guy and then find out you don't like it. Because at that point, the stigma's already there.
Yeah.
All right. Yes, Matthew.
Yes, sir. Hey, I was just calling to let you know this month's copy of Avid Golfer comes out every month. The January 08 cart girl and her fantasy date, you are it.
A cart girl where?
I'm not sure. The golf course. It's a golf course up near Kenny. I'm not even sure if that's a national magazine, but I do believe you can go to avidgolfer.com. It's a magazine that I know it's put out here monthly, every month.
Are you
and,
big?
There's a cart girl of the month.
You a big golfer?
She was cart girl for January 08.
I got it.
You're her fantasy date.
Okay. You play a lot of golf?
I try to.
Okay.
Much as possible.
What's your handicap?
I haven't even gotten to that yet. I've only been playing about a year, a little over a year.
How long did it take before you actually got into it? Because everybody said if you get past the irritation phase, you get stuck. You get hooked on it.
That was what it did to me. I was in the Marine Corps, and all my buddies tried to get me to play, and I never would. And first time my buddy Roy sent me to play, I fell in love with it. Because it's something you just continually try to beat, and you never will. And you just try to get better and better and better.
Let me try it one weekend just to see if I got it.
Get into it, they just get passionate.
Thank you, Matthew.
The one thing is, don't get frustrated with it the first time, because you are not going to get it the first time.
Okay. All right. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Semper Fi.
You could probably do it because you were stuck with a guitar. I thought you'd get frustrated and throw that guitar through the wall.
Well, the variables don't really change on the guitar. Your swing, wind conditions from course to course, that's going to vary, and that's going to... We played one time with Ludwig from the Stars, and we weren't really playing to hit the holes. We were actually aiming for the golfers.
Which is what you did. You hit a golfer. I know you're aiming for him, but that doesn't make it better.
If
I remember correctly, you had a pretty good swing.
Well, what do you call that? Is it a scramble?
Yeah.
Everybody's playing everybody else's ball? Whoever has the best ball?
Yes.
Okay.
But yeah, you'd be great. You would have fun because you can go out there, pretty weather, drink, hit balls at people, and just enjoy it.
Excuse me, but hit balls at people.
Yeah, you do.
Is there any liability? Because I guess if you're on a golf course, you just accept the fact you might get pinged.
Yeah, you just have to go four and not make it too obvious that you're aiming at them.
Oh.
Like you did. My roommate takes that magazine, though, so I'll look tonight.
All right. How are we doing, Chloe?
Breaking two.
All right.
But people get into it, man. They just get passionate.
Well, look at Bob McNeil when he was program director. He was, without exaggeration, he was probably here 25% of the time.
That's about right, yeah.
And the rest of the time, if you really wanted him, he always had a cell, but he was always on the golf course. No clue what was going on in the station. We could have run amok and gone on some F-word fit.
Mm-hmm.
just to see who could get it out the most in 60 seconds.
Man, anytime you called him, it's like when you pick up the two-way, you know Gavin's going to be there. Yeah. You picked up the phone, you called Gavin, you called Bob McGill, you hear, yeah, what is it?
What is it, Dan?
I was going to say, and if all that were to happen, you were to go on the F-bomb tirade and someone were to call Bob McNeil, he probably would have said something along the lines of, what's the big deal? I use it all the time, too.
Yeah. In what context does he use it?
Yeah.
Well, they're having a contest. Well, I told them to do more giveaways.
If you don't mind, yeah. It's tea time.
Was he talking about me or my golf game?
Now, I have to go because I'm playing in a rough part of town, and we have to skip the ninth hole because it's close to the freeway and someone could get shot. So I got to be going. I got to keep my eyes out. Because there was one time he played a golf course, wasn't really happy with a part of town, and he said, we skip one of the holes. It runs close to the freeway. And he goes, someone could get shot.
Never heard that story. Did you ever get pinged in the hall? When he'd go out in the hall and chip balls down the hall when he was here.
Well, that wasn't a full swing. That was just a...
It doesn't matter. It's a golf. It's a real... Get a wiffle ball. He was real golf balls. He'd step in the hall.
He actually tried the wiffle ball golf balls one time for practice in the hallway. He said he didn't like it because it messed up a natural feel. So when he went to the course, it jacked him up. So he said he wanted to be hardcore and old school about it.
You ever get pinged?
Yes. Yes.
I did.
I think we all have.
Well, you guys bitched that he was never here.
But when he was here, he was throwing things at us.
He was accessible.
Yeah, he was. He had to look around the corner before he walked.
Got to stick a mirror halfway out.
I'm not kidding. It got to the point where everybody walked around the corner, looked first, and then you turned the corner.
All right. You want a break here?
Yes.
Okay. Any other calls about menopause? Any pissed off older chicks? Any gay guys that want to sleep with older women?
None yet, but we know they're out there.
Yeah. Okay. Trannies.com.
I'll go look that up for the break. It's a real website.
All right, we'll be back.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
Why do you insist?
Let's promote the damn band.
Saying that breaking up is promoting the band?
It makes them more valuable. It puts, it makes it finite.
It does.
I better go see them on tour.
They're not finite, though.
How many bands beat us to death with that's it. Why die? No more tours. This is it. You don't see it this time? You better...
Ticket prices go way up. You're right. They do.
In fact, there was a class action suit against Barbara Streisand.
Good. I don't care what it was about.
They should have got her just performing. But she had a farewell tour.
And this makes sense?
The tickets were retarded.
Oh, I think people... It was in the thousands per ticket.
And then 4 or 5 years later, maybe not even that long?
I don't think it was that long.
She goes on tour again. I hope they nail her.
I do, too. It's ridiculous.
I hate her.
So many levels, but...
Hang on. Why do you hate her?
She just annoys the piss out of me.
You didn't like her in Meet the Falkers?
Actually, not really. Yeah. I think her voice is annoying. I hate her politics, and...
I don't know anything about her politics. Is that the two-way?
No.
Gavin, are you calling me?
No, I didn't.
All right. What are her politics?
Very liberal.
And she likes to get on stage in the middle of a show and tell you about it.
That's the other thing, that if I'm going to give you, I don't care if I'm giving you just $25.
Yeah.
I came here to get away from everything outside. Don't drag it back in and make some comment about the war, the president, the pilot. I don't care.
I don't care what you think specifically. I do may care about that, but I don't care what you think. And by the way, $25, when was the last time you bought a concert ticket?
I'm pointing out, even if I'm only throwing out a few dollars, I still don't want to hear anything from you.
That's true.
I came in to get away from reality. Don't drag it back in here screaming. And as big of an activist as the Don Henley is, I don't think he throws anything out at the Eagles concerts.
I don't think so. And I was about to say,
I never heard anybody complain about it.
They're the only group that's really been honest about it when they went, you know, reunion tour phase. I forgot how they worded it, but the
it was like our first farewell tour. We're going to do traffic here.
I can get Gail if you want.
No, I don't want to be pushy.
Not pushy at all.
And we normally do it here?
Yes.
Yeah. When Gavin came in after the show, we're trying to get the Bowling for Soup song down.
Okay.
And this is no shtick.
Okay.
Gavin came in and he said, if Jared can't make it for the white trash party, he said, I'm all over that song.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Is that right, Chuck?
Yep.
Joy is all over it, too. I mean, all over it.
Maybe she and Gavin can sing it.
No, she's not getting on stage. She's so pissed at me because I played that karaoke stuff.
What'd you bring new?
I didn't bring any new karaoke because she hadn't been at the house.
Oh, okay.
I got a nice little message from her earlier yesterday during the show.
Yeah. We're just front with audio in the last couple of weeks. Hi, Gail.
Hi, Russ.
What do you got?
Well, I've got wreck in Farmers Branch. Been there for a while. Northbound 35 before Valley View. Now it's off to the right shoulder, but traffic's backed up further to Northwest Highway. On Central, northbound at Lover's Lane, you still have the three left lanes blocked, and traffic's backed up to downtown. On northbound Simmons at Woodall Rogers, the right lane's blocked, so that's adding to your downtown backup. In Louisville, on southbound 35 at the 121 bypass, there's a wreck in the HOV lane. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
All right, thanks, Gail. In the 20s again tonight, very cold, and 52 for the high tomorrow. We're 54 and cloudy now in Live 105.3.
The joy on you.
Okay, I'm in Walmart getting hit, and I'm sitting over by the audio.
What's she getting?
Headphones.
All right. Is this for karaoke night?
Apparently. No, she listens to the show with headphones, and her headphones broke.
I thought she wasn't supposed to.
I give up that battle years ago. She's going to listen. She's going to get pissy. She was in Walmart, though. She, well, I'll let her tell you.
Hmm? But 4 or 5 years ago, you told her to stop listening to the show.
I told her. I said, and then I went to a phase where I said, even if you do listen, because you're going to listen anyway, or people are going to tell her, just don't bring it up. I don't want to fight about it after the show or on weekends, whatever the hell it is.
So you put your foot down.
Yes.
Let me see the bottom of your shoe.
It's.
I believe I'd like to have lunch on it.
It's down. It's been down.
And either Amy's a good liar or she doesn't listen.
She just knows not to bring it up. And Joy doesn't bring it up anymore, except when...
What about this?
She was in the Walmart and accidentally heard it. Plus, this is her. She feels attacked. She knows after... Well, when was the first day we played it? Monday? Yeah, because it would be recorded at Saturday. Or I recorded it. So she knew. And Monday, she sort of thought, all right, that's cute. Don't do that again. And then we played it again. I found more tracks.
Oh. Dan, what is line three?
I didn't completely understand it. It had to do with you being a jerk and something about you not liking reality.
Yeah, well, that's a good enough starter. Yes, Michelle.
I am so sick of you, Ross.
Do you know what else she had to say?
Just that you're a jerk and you don't like reality. You only like craziness.
All right.
And that you're a jerk.
Thank you. All right, you're back on the Ross Show.
Ross, I think you are so rude. I think the only reason that you are afraid to face reality is because it's real. And you live in La La.
Well, she's, again, very astute.
Yes.
Reality is really something that's real.
What is she mad about?
I don't know. I'm going to go back. I'm going to try and break this down into segments. I just wanted to...
Okay, is it going to be fat or is it going to be she's old?
All right. Why am I rude? Let's take this by segment.
You're rude because you classify women in categories of subservient behavior.
No, I don't believe I do. In fact, I said at an early age, when women are hot, they're in control of almost anything.
Right, but when we get old and all dried up, you want nothing to do with us?
No. Nature doesn't want me to have anything to do with you. That's why you've turned the way that you are.
That's why you take your pills.
Well, the pills aren't going to undo the way you look. They're just going to make you feel better about what you're having to go through.
Whatever, I can look good with any kind of surgery. And your attitude will never go away. You will always be a chauvinist pig.
I don't understand where you come from.
I come from Dallas.
I don't mean Dallas. I mean your perspective, you buffoon.
On Fifth Street.
Are you still there?
I am.
I don't understand why you don't like me, because I've said, I've covered the gamut as far as women go. You have your usefulness, and then you don't.
Well, I have my usefulness, and you're not. You know, here's the problem with you.
All right, how are you? How are you useful? Let's go that route, and maybe I'm wrong.
I can clean your house. I can do your dishes. I can do your taxes. And all you do is use me for one big hole.
How old are you now?
I'm old enough.
How old are you?
I am 34 years old.
Why are you so nasty at 30? Why are you nasty at 34?
Because the way that you treat me, the way you treat all women, is absolutely and completely uncalled for.
You don't know how I treat women off the air.
Oh, yes, I do. I heard something where you were banging on some woman's door while you're trying to take a duty.
Didn't I just say you don't know how I treat women off the air?
Well, the point is, you're still a chauvinist pig.
You haven't said why, though. You're taking an on-air, you're taking an on-air persona, and you just assume that it's real.
Oh, really?
Yes.
So, the point is you talk dirty, dirty things about women, and you make us look horrible to everyone, and I'm sick of it.
Is there anything that I can do to make you feel better?
Yes, what you could do is you could...
Lost interest.
Boy, she's that angry at 34.
She's narcotized. That's not just a natural 34.
No.
And Dan couldn't understand her when he was even trying to screen the call. Did she say anything else that she didn't get to?
No, that actually, you got way more out of her than I did. I just knew that she didn't like you, and that was good enough for me. And she was willing to tell you that on the air.
Does Valerie have a sister?
That sounded like...
No, I'll tell you what that sounded
swings.
Like. Remember that guy... went crazy about Britney Spears.
Yeah.
On that video.
The gay kid?
Yeah.
That's not who that sounds like.
To me, it actually sounded like your Amy, but almost like with like a sick throat.
After a couple of nice cartons.
Yes.
Of cool.
Very cool.
Or pell mell.
Yeah. It almost sounded like she didn't sound familiar to you at all.
No.
Because when she was talking to you, especially as emotional as she got, obviously she's a little kooky. But it almost sounded like she was saying the way, you know, when you treated me, almost like you dated her in the past or something.
That's almost what I got. And in fact, she got to that point, corrected herself, and said the way that you treat all women.
Right.
I wonder if that's somebody I've dated.
That was when she said that, and you said it, even though she corrected herself.
Because she took whatever it was, took it very personally.
Very personally.
Mm-hmm. And even more so than what you would take off the air.
Yeah.
Or that you'd hear on the air.
As you said before, screaming at a piece of equipment in your car. Radio.
Oh, yeah.
Unless she really does know you.
Trey, you already, the chick that ran into my garage?
Wow. Mothra.
Forgot about that name.
That would be about the right
age. Wow,
yeah, and that would be the right nuttiness, too.
Yeah, because it didn't take much to push her. And then you add a little bit of alcohol, and that was 5 years ago?
Yep. And she was in her late 20s at the time, which would be about a 14-year...
That totally makes sense. And that would explain the craziness, yeah.
What else she did? She had a rotten evening. We went out, I think it was for Rob's birthday. And because the focus wasn't on her, I took her. It was Rob... Wendy, and Trey, you went.
Yeah, it was your birthday.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, pretty sure.
That doesn't matter. It was a celebration, and she wasn't the focus. She didn't like it. She complains at dinner. She complains in the limo on the way back, and I'm thinking, if I can just get her home, I can get away from her, and I'll be done with
this. What happened at home is the strangest part of it. Even
well, when she gets to Everett's house, we stop because Everett's house is on the way back, and I met her through Everett. She goes inside. She complains to Everett.
evening has been an absolute nightmare.
And Everett said, you know what? Why don't you let me go back to Russ's house? I'll get your car. And then you bring it back, and you don't even have to go down there. No, I'll go up there and get it. She gets past that. And I didn't know she had said that to Everett until the day after. We get to my house. She goes in, takes all her clothes off, gets in the bed, and lays there. I walk in the bedroom and went, you're not staying.
I swear to God to this
unless
day.
Unless you're taking a little nap before you go to the house, you're not staying.
Unless you had plans to beat you. I really, really do. Why would you be that nutty, that crazy, that pissed off? And then just jump in bed naked. Go to sleep, honey.
And then she wants to talk about it as I'm kicking her out.
Yeah.
Standing at the front door. Can't we talk about this?
Sure. Well, was she hot? Because I never saw her.
Yeah. Okay, I mean, I wouldn't put her at a 10, but...
She's probably never been...
7.5?
Probably never, I was going to say 8, yeah. Never been kicked out of bed by any guy ever. I'm naked. He'll want me.
It's whatever was going to follow sex wasn't going to be worth anything that I got out of her.
No. And she was... God, I remember that dinner because she was pissy at dinner.
And it didn't stop.
That's like a first date, too.
No, we've been out a few times before. But this is the first time that I saw her like that. And then she's standing at the front door. It's probably around midnight. And she's loud. What? I got nothing else to say to you. There's nothing you can say to me standing at this door that's going to change anything. I'll be going to bed. Close the door. She goes out to her car. And she sits out there for a while. So I get on the Harley and I leave for a while. Pass the neighborhood, just keeping an eye. Her car's still out front. Pass the neighborhood. Car's not there anymore. I went, all right, she's waiting for me someplace.
That would scare me at that point.
I pull on a side street, and I can see her in the rear entry of my house, the driveway. Still got no clue what's going on.
She's waiting for you.
Pass a few more times. She's gone. Check the neighborhood. I go up one of the alleys.
You're such a man.
I don't know where the hell she's going to come from. I know she took that Toyota and parked it in a tree someplace and was waiting for me. I pull into the drive. Part of the garage door is... It's not crushed, but somebody driven into it.
Random. How whack you gotta be to do that? You know you're gonna get caught. You know you're gonna have to pay for it.
She didn't care.
She didn't stop.
Even the next day, when she was sober, she was laughing with other friends about it. She'd taken the little the ADD security sign.
Okay.
And beat on my door with it.
Tore your door up.
Then the flower thing, that possibly was the strangest. Well, she undid all your plants and threw them into the neighbor's yard.
Yeah, she actually left a note on the door and said, you don't deserve anything pretty.
Oh, my God. I didn't know that part.
Oh, yeah. Took everything out of the flower bed, front left, if it was in the front of the house and it was a flower, they were all yanked up and thrown on both sides. Neighbors, front street. I'm sorry I missed.
Yeah,
I was throwing them around.
It's been fun to watch on the video camera.
So now I got gashes on the door, I got no flowers, and I got a garage door that's been run into. I call Everett, and he said, I just got off the phone with her. She's toasted someplace. She's lost. I told her just to stay there or find a hotel if you can see it. And the next day, she's still bragging to her friends about it.
Yeah. Well, she's probably done that before. In fact, I think we heard a story later where she wigged out on somebody's boat and did some damage.
So that cost her a couple of grand in damages. And her attorney, well, she doesn't have that. Well, what you do is you check your bank account before you start wigging out on somebody's domicile. Because I'm not going to just look at everything you did and blow it off to some type of miscommunication.
Is that video still on your website?
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, I'll never forget that next morning. Get an email from Russ. Guess how my night ended. Thinking, all right, he got some sex. What? Then the pictures start coming in. I'm like,
oh, that's right. I took pictures and I went, are you guessing how this happened?
Mm-hmm. I remember those pictures. I'm like, this kid's door. A large dog.
And her attorney was adamant about, all right, you want $2,000. Well, that's what it's going to cost to fix everything. Well, she doesn't have that. She got $500 now. Well, possibly you should have some type of liquidation sale. Because if you don't, I can still call the police. She's already admitted she did it. Yeah. She admitted it to Everett, who's an officer of the court. That's admissible. You're jacked.
Yeah. That was, y'all settled pretty quick, though.
I think she had to sell something, but she came up with the $2,000. And I got a nice laptop. What were you about to ask?
I can't remember now.
Did she ever contact me afterwards?
Did she ever contact you?
Unless that was her a few minutes ago, no.
That sounded odd. Well, I never heard her, but boy, that chick was angry at you for some reason, more so than just a radio person.
And if I remember correctly, she did have kind of a a deeper voice than normal.
It was sort of raspy. It wasn't like that. Then again, that was 5 years ago.
Exactly.
And you don't know what's been in her throat. All right. Don't want to take any of these before we break?
Seven. Maybe this will jar your memory.
Yes, John.
Yeah, Russ. She mentioned all these things that she could do. She said she could do your taxes. Did you date an accountant in the past?
Hold on a second. What did that chick do? The obvious thing is accountant. She was in some profession. Was it accountant or was she worked at a dentist's office?
No, she worked for, I believe it was one of the big accounting firms.
That was probably it, John.
Because she explicitly said, I did your taxes. I mean, who says that?
I could do, yeah.
I'd have to go back and listen, but you're right. She threw out all the things that she could do. And one of them, she may have said, I've done your taxes.
Taxes aren't just something you throw out. Dishes and dinner, yeah.
All right. Thanks, John.
But not taxes.
It sure was a... the other chick that I dated was a nut that worked at some dental office.
Mm-hmm.
Probably created her own business.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you look a little loose.
Oh, no.
No. In fact, I think...
You dated some freaks.
Gavin.
Yes?
Did you date one of the chicks that I dated that was nutty?
No, I wouldn't do that.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
It was a chick with some... I think it was the dental one.
No, that was not how it happened.
All right, how did that
she
one happen?
She wasn't into dental either.
Oh, no. What did she do?
It was another doctor's field, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and I thought she might be interested in me, and she was dating you, and...
And then after we stopped dating, then you contacted her.
No, I didn't.
How did you guys hook up?
I told you about this.
How did you hook up?
I didn't hook up with her.
Why were you calling her?
I didn't call her.
I remember the story someplace that you hooked up with her after we stopped going out, which is fine with me.
No.
Anybody else remember this?
I completely remember the story.
Well, then why do you tell us and then we'll fix it?
We were out at Cape Buffalo. You remember?
No. Tell me the story.
Oh. We were grinding on the dance floor.
You and me?
No.
You and her?
We were all dancing, yeah.
Was I there?
Yes.
Okay. Why are you grinding with her on the dance floor while I'm still dating her?
No, we were all dancing. It's just a term. So we were dancing on the dance floor, and...
You like to do that with people's girlfriends, don't you?
Right. And you weren't really paying attention to her.
So you grinded on her?
No, so I was paying attention to her.
You were paying attention to her clam?
No, I was talking to her.
You're dry-humping her on the dance floor.
I was talking to her, and then we went dancing. It was fun. There were a bunch of people around. There were a bunch of us out.
Hold on. What is it, Dan?
If I remember correctly, and this is the night I'm thinking of, I think I was there.
Yes, he was.
Okay. Then I remember the girl that you're talking about.
Yeah. Very attractive.
Was Gavin all over her?
Of course. Actually, when they were on the floor dancing, you and I were talking about it, and even Tasa was there saying, why is Gavin humping on your woman?
Why is that, Gavin?
I wasn't humping on her.
Why are you humping my woman?
I was not humping her.
You just said, you just told her, told us you're grinding on her.
You know, it's a term.
Did you bang her? Dan Hotline's ringing.
No.
Did you bang her?
No. No. I thought she was making moves, so I approached you and I told you about it.
I don't remember that.
She called in.
All I remember is the big grinding on the dance floor.
She called in on the show.
Did you kiss her?
Absolutely no interest.
Did you kiss?
No.
Did you kiss her?
Why would I kiss someone that was dating you?
Because you're already pumping and grinding. Obviously, you want to kiss her. Did
no,
you kiss her? How'd I
no.
taste?
No. I always put people... No. That would be backstabbing to you.
And if we took your current girlfriend, and I'm on the dance floor with her, grinding up against her clam...
It's just a term. Yeah, yes. Absolutely. She grinds with people. Yeah. For on the dance floor, sure.
And you have no problem with that.
If you want to dance with her, I got no problem with that, because it's fun.
And we're doing the bump and grind.
Yeah, but we'd be doing it fake.
You're still rubbing genitalia.
Jeez. We're just dancing.
No, but both of you guys are out on the dance floor bumping clam heads. I just want to know why.
Dancing. Because you wouldn't dance with her, so I did. And I was dancing with a bunch of people.
Okay. And you didn't hook up with her afterwards?
No.
This was a chick with a big poofy hairspray head, right?
She was very attractive. Yeah, I'd say I saw her like a year later.
Big cans?
I forget. She had big cans? Obviously, you got a better look at them.
I don't know. God, see? I probably should have hooked up with her.
I think you did.
No, I didn't.
I've just forgotten part of the story.
It doesn't make any sense.
I'll find out. In fact, I believe she lived someplace in Rockwall, or the office was.
That's fine. You can find out.
I'll find her.
Well, that's fine. You can absolutely 100% find out, because I distinctly remember, you know, saying to myself, I'm not going to do this because I don't do this to people that, you know, I associate with.
You banged my girlfriend?
No, it wasn't your girlfriend.
I asked you again. Close laughing at something else. You bang her?
No.
Kiss her?
No, remember you hit
her. I don't remember anything. Why did I hide from her?
Because you drove back to your house. She's like, all right, I'll meet you at the house. And then you hid.
Oh, that's right. Because she couldn't remember exactly where I lived.
So you hid from her?
Yeah, I was done with her.
But you was telling her you're done with her.
It was a lot easier to let her get lost. I watched out the window and I saw her going up and down Midway. She forgot what side street it was.
Tell me where you were.
Yeah. I watched for you. What happened?
Saw you drive by several times.
Yeah.
I waved. I was waving by my curtains.
We need a break? All right. Anybody else you want to fess up to, Gavin, before I move on with this?
No, I can't.
Because all of a sudden, I have no trust.
I cannot believe this. This is unbelievable.
You have lunch with Joy. JD doesn't know anything about it.
That's different.
How's that different?
Because we're buddies.
I'm not in the loop on that.
I have been in social circles with her many times.
Yeah, and you grind on her, too.
You let him grind on her?
The two of them, where was it? It was over Firewater. I look over there, they're just grinding away.
It's not my fault you guys don't want to grind with your ladies.
I was busy. I went to the bathroom and come back and you're hanging on her. And then later you call her, and later you go to lunch with her.
Yeah, we're social.
Seems to be a habit with you.
I would never, ever.
Wait, nobody trusts you now. Thank you, though. Goodbye. What is it, Trey? I got a break.
Oh, there's an email about how you leave dates. Russ, your idea of how to get out of a bad date is pathetic. A real man would just be upfront about not being attracted to the woman, but you just disappear or
so you
have
wanna
a friend.
You want to be ugly to him. You actually want to tell somebody, I have no interest in you at all. I'm going to get up and leave. As opposed to just getting up, going to the bathroom, excusing yourself.
And making him sit there.
And then you vanish.
And get the check.
Well, then there's some mystery.
There's no mystery.
But if you're going to sit there and tell somebody while you're sitting there face to face, there's absolutely nothing that's going
there's
on here.
Way.
I have no interest. I'm going
to
leave.
There's a way to do it. You can just say, you know what? We're not hitting it off. The chemistry's just not here. Let me pay for the tab.
I don't like confrontation.
You don't like paying for the tab? You?
Sit down. You've been nothing but trouble this whole show. We need a break.
Yes.
All right, we'll be back.
When I start making love, I don't just make love. I be stroking. That's what I be doing. I be stroking.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
I stroke it to the east, and I stroke it to the west. And I stroke it to the woman that I love the best. I be stroking.
Like nothing you've ever heard before. The Russ Martin Show. To the Russ Martin Show.
Gail, what are you laughing at?
I'm not laughing, I'm just smiling for you.
Why?
The guy that called in earlier talking about the girl in the Avid Golfer magazine that said her ideal date would be with you.
Right.
They didn't have anything on their website, but I just, for the hell of it, typed her into MySpace, and I'm pretty sure I found her.
You send it to me yet?
I'm going to in just a second.
Okay. Did that guy, or does it say on the golfer website where you can get copies of that? Are they free like the Observer?
I think they're free. I think he mentioned that to me, but they tend to be, you know, at the golf courses in the area. They have three different publications in Texas, one in Dallas-Fort Worth, one for the Hill Country, and then another one, I think, for Houston.
Okay.
So regional/local.
All right.
Hi, Gail.
Hi there.
What do you got?
Well, northbound Central at Lovers, they cleared the wreck, but it's still backed up to downtown, and there's a wreck on the other side of downtown, northbound 35 at Woodall Rogers. It's in the right lane. On northbound 35E at Wintergreen in DeSoto, Lancaster area, the right lane's blocked by a crash. On westbound I-30, Tom Landry at Walton Walker, there's a wreck. Westbound I-30 before I-45, there's a crash on the shoulder. Traffic's backed up to around the Fair Park curve. And eastbound Service Road of LBJ past Coit, a wreck. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
It's Gail 29 for the low tonight. Going to be back into the 50s tomorrow. Still windy, though. It's 54 now at Live 105.3.
This chick's only 24.
And makes sense if she's a cart girl at a golf course.
Why would she pick somebody almost 50 to be her... She's a perfect date or
fantasy
or ideal date. Either way, I'm not sure what the exact question was, but
let me read about her. I go back to her, back to profile. Thank you. She's very attractive.
Is she?
Yeah. See. Hang on, let me click on one of her bikini pictures.
Ooh.
Look at those.
Yeah.
By any?
No. No.
Yes.
You're engaged.
Yeah, well, she can keep the ring.
You can't just go to the bathroom and ditch her like you do on the other dates.
Oh, that would be funny in his own house.
Go to the bathroom.
Here she is before her breast implants. She is with her breast implants.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Baby.
No.
Size of those things. I'm so horny.
Lovely. Too much information. Don't care anymore. Touching yourself every day.
Well, it's a testosterone gel.
We have to suffer.
There she is again. Some getting more bikini pictures. Looks like she took a trip to Lynchburg.
Really?
And where that would be, Trey?
The Promised Land.
Don't.
No.
Stop. Everybody bowing down. Ridiculous. Didn't you get offered a trip to Lynchburg?
Yeah, I think the master distiller, Jimmy, isn't it funny? I know his first name.
Uh-huh.
I don't know his first names in Congress.
No.
Look for some more pictures in her bikini.
What is it, Dan?
David on line two said he saw the magazine as well and remembers some of her bio stuff.
Yeah, I was,
Go ahead, David.
I was reading it and it said, who's my fantasy date? And it said, Russ Martin. He's hilarious. And you go down and you see, oh, what's your date? You like your age range? And it says, like, 18 to 34.
Oh. No, then maybe she doesn't know.
Maybe not.
All right. Thanks, sir. Oh, hey, where are you right now?
Fort Worth.
Oh, never mind. Let's see if somebody had the magazine, they could bring it by.
Oh, somebody will bring one by.
What, Dan?
I know you're looking at her pictures, and I don't want to take you away from that, so I'll just tell you. When you go down and look at her companies, as far as whom she works for, one of them actually says CBS Radio Dallas.
Let me go down.
So, since Gavin works in the other building, he may know her.
How far I got to go down?
It's the last box on the lower left when you scroll down.
At the very bottom?
Pretty close.
No, you went past it.
I would say with the cursor thing on the right, it's about halfway down.
Gavin, why are you in here?
I want to see her. See if I know
her. Are you trolling?
No, for you. So I can get in touch with her.
Let me go back up here. That's her.
Yeah.
You know her?
Yeah.
How do you know her?
She works over the other building. She works at Fitzy. Yeah.
She there now?
I've seen her. Yeah, I believe so.
Are you? No, leave your headphones on. You're not going anywhere.
Russ is about to do his first remote in years.
Did you know that she wanted to go out with me?
No.
Did you know?
No, how am I supposed to know?
Jesus, you just hit me!
Did you know?
No, you can't hit me!
He threw something
at me. You can't hit me!
Testosterone.
You hit me! You slapped your boss. Jesus.
You just hit our boss.
Backhanded him.
Mm-hmm. You did.
Like a bitch.
Yeah.
Stop on the testosterone.
A backhand isn't as bad as a fist.
It's an assault.
It's almost, that's the way that pimps control their bitches.
He's not your
so
man.
You don't damage the goods when they go back out on the road.
Oh, my God.
It's just something that's, it's to spark them up.
That's assault.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
Prove it.
It's a professional technique. Perfected by the pimps.
I understand. Backhanded bitch slap.
Dan?
Yes, sir.
What are you doing?
I was just scrolling down through her comment stuff, see if there was anything else, any mention of you.
Why don't you call KRLD, see if she wants to come on the air?
I'd be happy to.
Thank you.
You are engaged. Do you have a girlfriend? Why are you doing this? Why do you pursue this at all?
Because I'd like to screw her.
Well, what you'd like to do, what you're going to do are two different things.
No, not really.
You're engaged.
Well, maybe she's into experimentation.
Look at her mood.
Look at her what?
Her mood.
What's her mood?
Hopeful.
Yeah. Well, she can change that to satisfied. I'm screwing her.
Bet she makes a fortune being a cart girl.
Really?
Oh.
It's like the tub girls, like Gillies or whatever?
Yeah. They just drive
Cowboys.
Around in a bikini top, usually, if it's hot. And guys, you know, buy a $3 beer, pay them $6.
The size of those yams.
Let it go.
I can't.
Yes, you can. Turn it off. Hit the little X.
Even if I turn it off, the frustration's still going to be there. I'm going to need some type of release.
Don't look at me. Don't even look at me.
She is drunk on the floor.
She really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And she's wearing like a
top. Yeah.
A top that you could just pull straight down, and mm-hmm. It's only an inch right above her nipples.
Mm.
And those are my favorite kind of cans.
This is, you just let this go.
So let me get this straight, JD. If it was her fantasy to go out with you,
I would not, no interest.
You've sickened the old man. You wouldn't even entertain that.
No. I love Joy.
Would you like me to show you her cans again?
No, I don't need to see them.
She sends you these pictures and says,
oh, God, take that one off the screen. Take it off.
Nice little blue and white bikini, just barely covering up those cans. You nasty woman. That, again, maybe she doesn't know how old I am, or maybe she's never seen me. She's just going from what she's heard on the air.
She heard you on the air. She just doesn't care. You know, that's her age range for a normal guy. You're not a normal guy. You're on the radio.
Hang on. Doesn't this chick in this other picture, she used to work here? Work in our traffic department?
Yeah.
This one.
Barely looks familiar.
Yeah, okay, I don't care. I'm not screwing her. You find her, Dan?
I talked to someone over at the Fitzhugh building who is a friend of hers, and she is calling her for us, and she's supposed to be calling in.
Would you quit? What's the face?
I spent an hour and a half looking at porn today.
Okay. It's because you're on the testosterone. Get off of it.
No.
Get off of it, or double up on your lorazepam.
Here's another bikini picture. Look at those.
I see them.
And you wouldn't call, you wouldn't explore this, you wouldn't even email back.
No.
Just to say, you know, it's very flattering. Perhaps we could, you know, lunch.
No, lunches would be cheating unless I would tell Joy that I was going. It's not queer, it's cheating. Would you go out, Chuck?
Hell yeah.
Really?
Chuck's a mature man.
Well, I know he's also married.
He calls the queers as he sees them.
He's also married, and so are you. Almost.
Chuck's been in band since the fifth when?
Yeah, pretty much.
So,
all right, since the 70s.
Well, what does that mean?
How long you been married?
25 years.
All right. You don't think something's happened on the road?
No, not
by accident, of course.
How's any of this accidental?
Well, this won't be accidental.
No.
I'm gonna drive over there.
I'm surprised you haven't left already.
All right.
She'll come to you. I'm quite
Dan,
sure.
You want to do some news now? Maybe something morbid to relieve my erection.
I'll give it my best shot.
All right. We have time?
Yes.
Okay.
Then Gavin comes flying in here because now then he hears that it's somebody that possibly works for CBS.
Oh, several hot.
Then he's going to go try and get into that before I can get over there.
There's several very hot chicks over there.
I don't trust anybody here now.
Oh, please. Who do you don't trust me?
No.
Why?
We've covered that.
I haven't done anything. I never did anything.
You used to visit my ex, and I didn't know about it.
She was your current at the time. And you guys were having problems. She called me and said, I don't know what to do with Russ. Will you come talk to me?
I don't want her to cheat, so I'm going to go help my buddy Russ out and plant my penis as a bookmark.
And I... given my
as
hand
in, like a little safety thing.
I've given my hand on the Bible. I've had lie detector tests. I never did anything to her. Nothing. Never even touched her. Saw her naked once.
She worked in the mall.
No, she did not.
Yes, she did.
No, she did
Why
not.
Why would she be naked at Gadzooks?
She was in Cabaret Royale when I saw her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. No, I don't trust anybody.
Oh, please. I've done anything to you.
If this chick was dating somebody here, sent me these pictures, mm-hmm. or sent anybody else these pictures, and she's dating me, said, hey, I want to hook up on the side, all of you guys would bang her.
I wouldn't. Much? No, I wouldn't.
What is it, Gavin? I got to move on.
I wouldn't either.
Yes, you would. And you're the last person now that I trust.
I was trying to help find her so we could track her down.
I got Dan for that. Thank you. Wheel. Ready, Dan? What?
I have Brittany on the phone for you.
Good with the shaking. Mm-hmm. Like a chihuahua in the rain. She can't see you. You don't have to fluff your hair.
Shut up. I'm Brittany.
Hi.
How did you end up in the golf magazine?
Well, I work at a golf course and was nominated. They asked me to be January's Cart Girl of the Month.
Have you ever seen me before?
I've seen pictures.
All right.
Never met you personally.
And why would I be somebody you'd want to go out with? I'm open for it. I'm not trying to queer the deal.
I don't know. I listen to you every day. Make me laugh.
I thought your cutoff for guys was 34.
I make an exception.
You'd go all the way up to almost 48?
Sure.
You date anybody now?
I don't know.
What time do you get off over there?
I'm already off.
Can you come by?
I actually just got home.
What part of town is that?
In Arlington.
Arlington?
Mm-hmm.
Can you come by here?
Maybe. I passed by your studio yesterday.
I mean, right now.
Right now? Yeah. They let me in.
Yeah. I'll take the door off the hinges. I'd probably do it from here.
Oh, my God.
Wear something nice and nasty.
Wear something nice and what?
Nasty.
And nasty.
Yeah.
I don't know that I have anything nasty.
Wear that bikini that you got on your MySpace page.
Oh.
What time can you be here?
You really want me to come in?
Yes.
Well, I don't know. I guess you're like 20 minutes away.
Yes, leave right now.
Really?
Yes.
I'm kind of nervous.
Well, there's nothing to be nervous about. There are other people here to hold you.
Down.
Easy.
Okay.
All right. See you in a little bit. Don't jack me around.
Oh, I won't.
All right. Thank you.
You're my dream date.
Yes, we'll be.
What is wrong with you?
I'm horny.
No, well, that's fine. You have a woman for that. Have her come up here.
Nah, she's menstruating.
Well... So you're getting...
And because of this testosterone,
yeah.
I woke up one morning this week, and it's now.
Okay.
It's go time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm waking her up. Well, why don't we have some sex?
Sure.
Well, I'm on my period. Well, then what do I do with this? She goes, why don't you go take down the rest of Christmas lights with her?
She's funny. I like her. Must be get a flag.
Danny, you ready now?
Sure.
Okay. I got nothing to say.
I figured you don't. You're not going to have anything to focus on until she gets here. I am Dan O'Malley on the Russ Martin Show with news. Today is Wednesday, January 30th, 2008. Today's news is brought to us by Russ's Wang. Birthdays today. Wilmer Valderrama turns 28. Christian Bale, the new Batman, of course, turns 34.
Brittany's coming.
Yes, Brittany's coming.
Brett Butler is 50. Phil Collins is 57. Dick Cheney turns 67. Vanessa Redgrave is 71. Gene Hackman is 78. And Dick Martin from Rowan and Martin's Laugh-In is 86. And on this day in history, back in 1969, the Beatles made their last ever public appearance as a group, performing on the roof of Apple Studios in London. The show was stopped when police arrived after neighbors complained, of course, about the noise.
May I go bang her on the roof?
No. I didn't bang her at all.
It's more bikini pictures.
You haven't cheated in 2 years, 3 years, how many years now?
Three. A couple of years.
Three.
2 years.
Good.
It was a solid run.
Yeah.
You're not going to cheat today. We'll all be here to make you strong. Quit looking at her pictures.
You can stand in the way all you want.
You're like a roided up, sexed up Pac-Man.
Man. Okay.
Stand in front of her and try and block her.
I will.
You go home looking like a donut. Go ahead, Dan.
Okay. Democrat John Edwards bowed out of the race for the White House on Wednesday, saying it was time to step aside so that history can blaze its path in a campaign. Okay. Now left to Hillary Rodham Clinton and Barack Obama.
Who stepped aside?
John Edwards.
Yeah. He was a roadblock.
Speed bump.
Goes back to the debates the other day. There are three people in this debate. No, not really.
Edwards said,
what guy?
21.
All right,
go ahead, Dan. Edwards said Clinton and Obama had both pledged that they will make ending poverty central to their campaign for the presidency. The former North Carolina senator did not immediately endorse either Clinton, seeking to become the first female president, or Obama, the strongest black candidate in history.
Now,
yes.
Spring of 2006, I had the extraordinary experience of bringing 700 college kids here to New Orleans to work. These are kids who gave up their spring break to come to New Orleans to work, to rehabilitate houses because of their commitment as Americans, because they believed in what was possible, and because they cared about their country. I began my presidential campaign here to remind the country that we, as citizens and as a government, have a moral responsibility to each other. And what we do together matters. We must do better if we want to live up to the great promise of this country that we all love.
Which one of the candidates said, he wasn't blatant about it, but he said, you know, I don't have the cash to compete with these other people. Was it Edwards?
No, he's got the cash.
All right, well, whoever else backed out,
Giuliani.
That was one of the things. It's not going to be Giuliani.
No.
Who's left?
Kucinich backed, was, I think, the latest one back out from the Democratic Party.
It'll come up in the news. Go ahead, Dan.
And Rudy Giuliani told supporters today he is abandoning his bid for president and backing Republican rival and longtime friend John McCain. Once the Republican presidential frontrunner, the former New York mayor suffered a debilitating defeat in Tuesday's Florida primary. Giuliani finished a distant third to the winner McCain and close second place finisher Mitt Romney. After the result, Republican officials had said Giuliani would endorse McCain today in California.
We got audio from John McCain basically saying, best wishes to the rest of you guys. See ya.
My friends, this was a hard-fought election and worth fighting hard for. But I've been on the other side of such contests before and experienced the disappointment. I offer my best wishes to Governor Romney and his supporters. You fought hard. You fought hard. You fought hard for your candidate, and the margin that separated us tonight surely isn't big enough for me to brag about or for you to despair. Governor Huckabee and his supporters, as always, brought
so you go through the whole list of everybody that lost.
Just the three, and then Giuliani
is going to back out sometime today. We don't always have enough of in these contests, good humor and grace. Thank you, Governor Huckabee.
How are we doing, Chloe?
Need a break.
No.
So you think Gavin going to lunch with one of our chicks is cheating?
Yeah. Well, if you don't tell somebody, yeah, it's cheating.
And Joy didn't tell you that she was going to lunch with Gavin.
No, she didn't.
So she cheated.
Yeah, pretty much. Brittany getting here.
Dan, did you call her back to make sure she was really coming?
Unfortunately, I didn't have time. You hung up on her to get her cell number. I wanted to get her to you as quickly as possible. But I can call over at the other building and get it if need be.
Yes. Yeah, this look of urgency on you.
Brittany's coming.
If you had those yams coming to see you.
Yeah, you're right. And as long as I do whatever I'm going to do, and I will, on the air, it's part of the show.
It's also cheating.
No.
You can't bring a woman in here, screw her, and say that's not cheating.
Yeah, it's kind of like a business write-off.
No.
So somebody has a sex scene in a movie, and that's cheating.
If it's full-on intercourse and your mate doesn't approve, yeah, that's cheating.
I mean,
your mate doesn't approve, or your mate.
I think if it's in a movie, it's... If it's there's no infidelity.
No, it's still infidelity.
If you have an entire crew around and somebody's shooting it for a reason, then at that point, it's art.
Trey, get the camcorder.
And we'll be back.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
That you're going to know very soon is on her way.
She's called back?
I spoke to her friend that put her in touch with us and said she already sent her a text saying, I'm on my way.
Let it go. Mm-mm. Yes.
Nope.
And I'm not going to finger any part of your body either, like you asked me off the air. All right.
Hi, Gail.
Hi, Russ.
What are you doing?
You know, just traffic.
What do you got?
I got westbound LBJ at Webb Chapel, stall car in the left lane, and it's back up to Marsh. And then westbound I-30 before I-45, there's a stall car on the shoulder. Traffic's back up to Peak. Walton Walker ramp to eastbound I-30, a crash, but it's on the shoulder. Midway northbound past 190, the two left lanes blocked, and in North Richland Hills, westbound Mid-Cities Boulevard before Davis is closed. You got to back up to Amundsen Drive. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
Thanks, Gail. All right, cold again tonight, down into the 20s, mid-50s tomorrow. It is 54, and kind of still windy at Live 105.3.
Where's the audio from Joy that I never got to?
That's over here.
She was where?
She was at a Walmart getting a pair of headphones. In the electronic department, I suppose.
So the radios were on there and the station was on?
Yes.
Well, you don't even know if that's true.
I have no idea. I know she's twisted at me.
Because you've been playing her karaoke.
I thought it was funny. She knows she can't sing.
I'm in Walmart getting headphones, and I'm sitting over by the audio area, and all of a sudden, out of the speakers of this little boom box they have turned on, is my voice coming out singing karaoke on your show. I thought that you said you weren't going to play anymore. I thought you said you weren't going to have any more of those cuts go on the radio. Jeff?
You tell her that?
Monday, yeah. I said I didn't think I had any more, but then I found the two more.
Oh. Is this them?
Yep.
Have I already listened to everything so far?
Yes, you've heard everything. It's Mustang Sally, 1985, and Crocodile Rock.
Brittany will be here what time?
Leaving Arlington, depending on traffic, and it seems to be clear coming from her place, I would think 15, 20 minutes.
Yes, everybody move for Brittany. You want traffic to... Right apart for her. Yeah. If we can get her one, escort her in.
I actually did think about a police escort, but I don't know anyone on duty right now in that area.
Okay.
No more. You said after Monday, ha-ha, nice and funny, and now that I'm in my car, what the f*** is wrong with you? Seriously, what the f*** is wrong with you? Why would you do that to me? Why?
But you guys didn't cuss at each other.
She's obviously very, very pissed off. She normally doesn't.
So you lied to her, and she's cussing at you.
Yeah.
That's a healthy relationship.
It is. It's good. You get it out, and that way it's over by the weekend, hopefully.
I asked you not to. You said you wouldn't. And you said that, oh, it was just for my... It was funny. Ha-ha. Thought the audio was cute. That's what you said. Okay, I'm going to stay along for one day. But I get to work today, and this Crocodile Rock to me when I get in the stupid, you know...
Security guard was singing Crocodile Rock there when she walked in.
What kind is that? I forgot I had that one.
Crocodile Rock is, sure.
My friends heard that, JD. My friends heard that. And now they're making fun of me. I mean, they're teasing me today. And, you know, okay, one time's fine. That's funny. Ha ha. But damn, I can't believe you did this. I am so mad at you. I am so mad at you. Do you understand? I am getting you back. Don't sleep. Don't you go to sleep. Don't you do it. And you know what? I never even ratted you out.
Yeah, you don't need to hear anymore.
Is there something else?
Nope. That's it?
No. Oh, all right.
About standing downstairs naked singing karaoke by yourself singing.
There's nothing else on the tape.
If you didn't want me to hear that, you really would have cut that one out.
I gave it to David to bleep. I forgot you said
and
that.
I'm getting you back.
I thought she was...
Don't sleep. Don't you go to sleep. Don't you do it. And you know what? I never even ratted you out about standing downstairs naked singing karaoke by yourself singing Mac the Knife when you thought I was doing something else.
That, the machine is addictive. It really is fun when you start singing.
Were you using props?
No. Just singing Mac the Knife. It's the one song I think I know. I was a shark. No.
Mm-hmm. Didn't tell anybody about that, but you know what? I just meant to tell a few people. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm so getting you back. I am so pissed. Call me back. Call me back. Bye.
When did she look at that message?
Yeah, it was yesterday during the show.
Did you call her back?
I talked to her last night. Finally, she's still mad at me. She was at home with her kids, so she couldn't scream.
And people at work are giving her grief?
Yeah. Security guard is, hey, Crocodile Rock girl.
All right. Anything else before we get to news?
Yeah. Two things, actually.
All right, make it quick.
Somebody heard Dan Lewis in town. Doing a weather report.
Did you get calls about this, Dan?
Yeah, I've gotten a couple of calls today.
WBAP at 8:30 last night. Dan Lewis. Could this be the Dan Lewis? It sounds like it. Like I remember him.
Actually, a guy just called in not 5 minutes ago and said, I think I heard Dan Lewis stumbling through the news at 7 o'clock on BAP last night.
So obviously they gave him the night shift.
It would seem to be.
Not newsing.
Do they have a news number over there that you call with breaking traffic and stuff?
A tip line? I would think so.
I'm sure they do.
Yeah.
Why?
During the next break, Dan, check in on their website and see.
Why? Let the guy up for air. Come on.
He was in Victoria for a couple of years.
I know.
Okay, he had plenty of time to suck it in.
No, you didn't. You wrote him the whole time he's down there.
He's down there concocting his own stories of how he ended up in Victoria.
That's pretty funny. That is pretty good. Well, I was in Dallas. I ran the Russ Martin Show.
I was the driving force.
Now, why are you here?
I've decided to venture off onto my own into poverty.
We still have Everett's demo. Oh, you
know. Do we still have Everett's demo?
Don't play this.
I think Everett's is on a disc.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, can he get him fired from BAP?
Oh, Dan?
Yeah.
How?
Discrediting him if he's supposed to be, you know, news guy?
Well, if they didn't go back and check his resume, that's their... they know he hasn't been on radio for 12 years.
That's the... yeah. Well, again, I'd like to see the resume. Because if he said that on where we heard... It's got to be documented somewhere. He's added years somehow, because we all know that's not true. It's impossible.
Between Dorsey Hawkeye and Mark Davis, we should be able to get a copy of his
that's true.
Resume or his app. What cut?
9 and 10.
My name is Dan Lewis. I have over 12 years of experience in Dallas radio.
Somebody asked me. I didn't write this forever.
You didn't?
No.
Oh. Oh. All of which...
Back it up.
My name is Dan Lewis. I have over 12 years of experience in Dallas radio, all of which occurred during a six-year period of time. For 30 years, I was the producer of the Russ Martin Show. Fortunately, I was surrounded by a sufficient measure of talent that my mediocrity was largely obscured. As a result, my wife, Laura, was able to convince a somewhat inebriated program director to give me my own show. A glowing jewel of the firmament, the Dan Lewis Show was so successful that it was canceled almost immediately from one station.
Well, the upside to all of this is now Dan doesn't have to pay on the RussMartin.info site to hear webcasts of the show. You can get it for free.
You can get it for free. He's probably on the way to work right now if he's working the night shift.
Well, there. What am I saving him? $10 a month?
Yeah. You've helped him at every turn.
Thereafter, casting another into the tempestuous throes of bankruptcy. I have been married to the same lovely woman for over 24 years, to whom I and nine of my meaty digits have been completely faithful.
I forgot about that part. I was taking a drink of fresh cake and out my nose. I and nine...
The only reason I can think that Dan Lewis would come back and fess up to Laura that he had actually fingered some chick in Mexico during one of our trips is Dan and I stayed in the same room.
Yeah, and you...
And so I knew about it that night, and that was his... And he knew I was either going to, A, use it on the air,
yeah,
or use it on him.
Yep, you're right.
So that was his way come to back. Defuse this. Sure. All right, here's a bit that we cooked up. I'm giving you the heads up in case anybody calls.
And we were all downstairs by the pool. Where were you that night, by the way? Oh, you were getting rid of the gun. That's right.
Yeah.
Forget. Here it is.
I have been married to the same lovely woman for over 24 years, to whom I and nine of my meaty digits have been completely faithful. We have two or three children whose names I might recall if, in so doing, it did not otherwise compromise my narcissism. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers.
What's the next cut on here?
Is part two of Everett's little Dan Lewis thing.
Oh, okay.
The job of vitamin salesman is not an easy one, of course.
Do we have the original disc of Dan's demo?
Cut 17.
On this?
Yes.
All right.
You have to hear this to appreciate Everett's.
My name is Daniel Lewis. I have a little more than 12 years of experience in Dallas-Fort Worth radio, plus an additional year of experience as host of the Morning Rehab program on 106.9 The Rock in Victoria, Texas. A great deal of work in the production studio, having taken hundreds of thousands of client commercials from inception to completion, and I also have a working knowledge of the majority of the software programs that it takes to get a radio program on the air. And for the software programs I don't know, well, I am a very quick study. I learn software programs very quickly. Admittedly, I'm something of a geek. In high school...
All right, where's the one where he goes off on the pronunciations?
Cut number 18.
Not an easy works of Wolfgang Amadeus, Ludwig von Beethoven, Johann Sebastian Bach, and Richard Wagner are discussed regularly. Problems present themselves in uttering the sibilant mellifluous cadences of such sounds as Hans Schmidt's Schkarosher and the Hammerklavier Sonata. One must weather the complications of L'Orchestre de la Suisse Romanade, the Concertgebouw Orchestra of Amsterdam, the Liebchen Gewandhaus Orchestra, and other complicated nomenclature. However, it must by no means be assumed that the ability to pronounce L'Orchestre de la Société de Concerts du Conservatoire de Paris with fluidity and verve outweighs an ease, naturalness, and friendliness of delivery when at the omnipresent microphone. For example, when delivering a diatribe concerning Vladimir Horowitz.
The only way that Vladimir Horowitz's name is going to come up now, if he's on a backup on 820.
The stock show.
Yeah. All right, now, what's back to Everett is 9?
9, yes.
My name is Dan Lewis.
No, I want the follow-up.
Oh, number 10.
The job of vitamin salesman is not an easy one. Of course, the relative benefits of dibasic calcium phosphate, magnesium oxide, potassium chloride, and microcrystalline cellulose are discussed regularly. I know nothing of these matters, which is why I have decided to, as it is known in common urban parlance, rap for you. Upon my 8th conviction for wanton boorishness, I was incarcerated for a period of time at a maximum security prison facility. What follows is a cautionary tale, a prison prose primer, as it were. Chilling.
Never. What zone does he get into writing this?
Don't ask me something like that,
all right?
Close is a cautionary tale, a prison prose primer, as it were. Chilling with my homies down in cell block 6 when my celly bends me over and I start turning tricks. Now they all line up so I can scratch their itches, shave the hair from my ass. I'm now one of their bitches. Giving up my booty for a pack of smokes, I'm the butt of more than just jailhouse jokes. I suppose it doesn't matter because it's sex that sells. By the way, sailor, is that a pack of Pell-Mell? Because today I've got to go out and earn me a carton.
Here it comes.
I had to shut Trey's mic off.
I understand.
Else. By the way, sailor, is that a pack of Pell-Mells? Because today I've got to go out and earn me a carton. But that's all right. I can take a c*** like a Spartan. So on trembling hand.
How are we doing, Club?
Breaking six.
All right.
Else, by the way, sailor, is that a pack of Pell-Mells? Because today I've got to go out and earn me a carton. But that's all right. I can take a c*** like a Spartan. So on trembling hands and on callous knees, I assume the position and get ready to please. My hole is ablaze, such a burning sensation. I've just pleasured everybody in the Aryan nation. They've been decking my halls with boughs of their holly. Now, I have more tobacco than Sir Walter Raleigh. But I'm not just another penitentiary hoe. I'm the famous Dan Lewis from the Dan Lewis Show. So I'm out of the pen and am in need of a job. I'll be your personal doorman. Let me grind on your knob.
Yeah, that's sad. Dan, who's on the hotline?
Brittany.
Where is she? If she's not coming, don't tell me.
Yeah, give me 1 second, Brittany, okay? I'm giving her directions. She's on her way.
She just now leaving?
No. She's already on 183.
Oh.
I'm just guiding her in.
Okay.
Here to help you.
All right.
Relax. What is this? You're not going to do anything when she gets up here.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I'm here to keep you from that.
All right.
You're my friend. I want you to be strong.
Okay.
And have a good marriage.
Which part of your body do you not really care about? Because that's the part that I put in front of me.
Brittany's coming.
Oh, God.
Brittany's coming.
Ha! Damn! Brittany's coming!
Let it go.
Mm-mm. Just a chick. She's a 24-year-old golf cart chick.
So? Why?
I have no explanation, but I'm her fantasy date.
All right, and you're going to do nothing except look at her and talk to her.
All right.
And that's all. It's like any other girl, like any other woman.
We need to write her a love song before she gets here.
That'd be good. Well, no.
Yes.
No, I love that. No, yeah. I wouldn't do that one.
All right. Danny, you done so we can do news?
Sure. All right. I say sing it. I mean, what girl doesn't like a song being written after her?
Yeah.
It's inspiration. She's his muse. It's only fair he share it with
la,
her.
La, 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 Brittany.
Yeah.
And then the next line about her clam.
Well, it's a... pros.
No.
It's got to rhyme. All right. 521, Dan O'Malley's here with news.
Thank you, Russ. The House voted 385 to 35 on Tuesday to approve an estimated $146 billion stimulus package aimed, of course, at countering the slowdown in economic growth.
I thought they got locked up in the Senate. Is that right?
It's still in the Senate. The House has passed it, but the Senate now has...
But the Senate wants to make some changes.
Yes, they do. A number of senators have said they want to amend the plan. Both chambers sent out flares indicating there will be hard-headed negotiating ahead. The battle is likely to be conducted at high speed since lawmakers say they want a stimulus package delivered for the president's signature by mid-February. The House bill calls, of course, for the one-time rebates to go primarily to individuals making less than $75,000 and to married couples making less than $150,000. The Senate proposal differs from the House plan in a number of ways. Here are some of the sticking points. Who should get the rebates? Should they go to senior citizens and more six-figure households?
John, even if they move the cap up, you're still not going to get any cash.
Why?
Because
they're going to take the cap off. Why wouldn't I get no cash?
Well, they're probably still going to stair-step it up to a certain point, and you're still not going to get anything.
Why?
This Would you guess, Trey?
Yeah. You make too much money. You're not going to get it. This one says right here, where does it say? Where does it say it?
Read it, Dan.
The last part. The Senate proposal also eliminates income caps on who would qualify for a rebate, which means all tax filers, not just low and middle income households targeted by the House plan, would receive one.
So everybody would get the $600.
I doubt it. I think it would be everybody, if they were to extend it that much.
Well, if you remove the salary cap, then everybody's going to get the same thing.
They would get the same thing, but it may not be that $600 or $300 or the $1,200, whatever. It could mean...
So they still insinuated they'll still scale it down after a certain point.
Yeah, because when they had mentioned at another time of, you know, extending it out to the Social Security and the unemployed, they were saying if that were to happen, the average rebate would be $500 instead of the $600. So if you extend it even further, it could be $300 for everybody.
I'm okay with that as long as everybody gets the same thing.
No, you're not.
Why?
And I'll tell you why. Because first thing they're going to do, it's going to be senior citizens. Low-income senior citizens.
People should get that.
And then the next group is going to be low-income families.
Okay. I'm still on the train. Go ahead.
You're not going to get it. It's not going to come out.
You just said I was.
It's not going to come out of the House Senate negotiation without a cap.
They're going to have to do that because right now we're at almost $150 billion. If you include everybody, it's going to at least double it, won't it?
At least.
Still. And they're not going to approve that. Still. So it's going to stall in the Senate.
No, I think they'll they both want to get it done, so there'll be a joint Senate-House negotiation to put the bill together.
Do you think they threw this thing in of, hey, let's remove the salary cap just to appease the populace and then go back, take it off? But you can still point out, we gave it a shot. We wanted you to have it, but because of President Bush, we weren't able to pass that through, so we had to go back to what he wanted.
Screw job.
It'll be for greedy bastards like JD who want money, who don't need it, that they are appeasing.
In, I should get money out. It's that simple. It's taxes.
That's fair enough, but that's not the way that they're going to do this.
Well, that blows. It's just stupid.
You're right. There's nothing equitable about it. Anything else, you put more in,
you should get something.
Proportionally, you should get the same percentage out. So if somebody gets $600 and they're only putting in $50,000, then obviously percentage-wise, you should get a lot more than $600.
And I'm going to stimulate the economy because I'm going to go out and spend it. Now my vacation's off.
I don't know why you plan a vacation around it. You never were going to get anything. What, you hear this news story come out today and all of a sudden you start booking things to Belize?
Yeah.
They ain't sending you dick.
You have plenty of money. You don't know that.
Yes,
first
we
of all,
do.
No, you don't.
You've talked about your investments and how good you've done.
You don't know that.
You make a nice.
Why are you looking at new houses?
I've been in that house for 3 or 4 years. It's increased in value. I was going to step up.
And a new truck.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Well, the truck's at 2004. Starting to have rattles. The right door window that doesn't roll down. Little things like that.
Somebody gets stuck in it?
No. Nobody's been stuck in it.
All right.
Just the room when it doesn't roll down.
Uh-huh.
Little things are starting to go wrong. I want a new truck.
So you got money for a new house, a new truck.
Well, the truck's not an investment. The house is.
All right. You got the cash.
I don't, and I want it, most importantly.
The poverty roll doesn't play well on you. That's my shtick.
Okay. I still want it.
Anything left in that story, Dan?
No, we got it all.
No. How are we doing, Claude? Where's the bottle?
Thank you.
You'll have whiskey on your break when you... Brittany gets here?
I'm not going to have too much. I don't want to get the whiskey stick.
Being that she has pictures on her MySpace page of going to Lynchburg, that's probably like an aphrodisiac.
It could be like cologne.
Oh, God, that's hot.
A chick with big breasts.
They went to Lynchburg.
Yeah. Loves Jack Daniel.
Went to take a tour of the Jack Daniels distillery.
Would you two like to hug, maybe? You, Trey?
Yes. Congratulations.
He's just right home to you.
That's all right. We both have hard-ons.
Okay. Is that some kind of a spacer? You don't get quite touch if you both have hard-ons?
Oh, no, they touch.
I don't want to know this. Yeah.
What's the matter, Dan?
Nothing.
I think we're all disturbed at this moment.
All right. I'm going to go stand up front and wait.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
Hi, Russ.
What do we got?
We have got, well, really heavy traffic, mostly. A few problems causing it. Stemmons between 30 and the Loop 12 Walton Walker merge real slow in both directions. Westbound LBJ pretty much heavy from Central over to Stemmons. Now on southbound 75 Central at 635, someone's changing a tire, mostly over on the shoulder. And eastbound LBJ, you hit a stop-and-go situation at Greenville. Doesn't loosen up till you get past Jupiter Road. A wreck in Fort Worth on 820 eastbound at Quebec, and then on Buckner at 175 in Pleasant Grove, there's a wreck. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
Nice feel cold tonight into the upper 20s and in mid-50s tomorrow at 51 now at Live 105.3.
All right, she's here?
Yeah, she is here.
Brittany is here.
Well, then go fetch Brittany. Was that the two-way?
Yes.
What is it, Gavin? Gavin! What do you want?
Didn't say anything. Good luck.
All right, what was the click thing?
That sounded like that to me. The two-way. And we're just getting interference.
Oh. Hey, Trey.
Hi, Russ.
What are you doing? Hanging out. What'd I tell you to go do?
Well, she brought her boyfriend.
Why?
I don't know.
I would. All right, if I was him, I'd go.
She said she didn't have one.
I don't think that's exactly what she said.
What did she say?
I think you asked her if she had a boyfriend. She said either maybe.
So I think she said, I don't know.
Yeah.
We're going to get rid of him. Do I want to see her?
Yes.
Is she hotter than her pictures?
Yes.
I don't want to see her.
Why? People have boyfriends. You're not doing anything with her anyway.
I can't start a relationship with a chick that's going to start out by lying to me.
You can't start a relationship anyway. You're engaged.
Sometimes things don't work out.
That's what you're going to put it to Amy? On the way home. Sometimes things don't work out. Get out.
Y'all want to see her or not?
Yes. You want to go get her?
All right. Tell her she's not going to be in here long.
Okay.
Maybe the boyfriend won't last.
Why bring him?
He probably called. I think the truth is he heard you talking about her and said, you don't leave until I get home.
Now, we'll find out. And I look.
It's very nice.
Like fan?
You know, just sucking your gut.
No. Trey, yeah, stick it right there. Why's your boyfriend here?
He's a big fan.
I don't like him. Trey, do me a, be a good fella. Go out there and shoot him in the head.
No.
And then she'd have nowhere else to turn for her grief but you.
Yeah, I'd go with you to funeral.
Yeah.
Now, whose idea was it for him to come?
I asked him to come.
Why?
Because I know he wanted to meet you.
he's not going to meet me now because I'm about to get rid of you.
All right, goodbye.
Oh.
What am I going to do with her?
I don't know. What are you going to do with her?
Well, he's not going to stand out there and let things go on in here.
You weren't going to do anything anyway. You know he's engaged, right?
He was prepared.
You know Russ is engaged?
Yes.
Okay.
He's prepared for what?
You.
Well, if he listens, he knows what's going to go on. We don't really have a pinball machine in here.
No.
No.
But the other things happen.
We did see firecrackers out there.
Well, I got nothing to say. I'm disenchanted.
Lord. She's still beautiful.
I don't care.
You don't care anymore at all?
She brought her boyfriend.
Well,
a lot of times, even if you're dating somebody and you're away from them, you know, you figure, all right, you know, we're on the air. Nobody's going to see this. He's not really going to be hip to anything.
Well, he's not in here, so it's all a bit.
All right. Can we see your... Are you going to be able to see those? What if I turn the mics off? No? No? All right, Trey, drag her out of here.
Trey, drag her.
And you know what? Still be a good fella and shoot him in the head. I get worked up for
An
hour and a half?
Yeah.
Almost 2 hours?
You have sweepers made. Like David just don't.
I did hear your song. I liked it.
I was working on a love song. I got promos running to you. You bring your boyfriend up here. What kind of tribute is that? This isn't going to last. What do you want, Dan?
You're not the only one in pain. Take line one.
What is it, Sean?
She has let the whole entire Russ Martin audience down. Any woman knows that she's supposed to shut up there by herself.
Yeah, if you've been a... Thanks, Sean. If you've been a listener, you know to come up by yourself. Plus, what's really going to happen? This is still a CBS company. Things can't happen unless you want them to.
Well, I didn't think things were going to happen. I didn't bring him up here as my bodyguard.
Why'd you bring him? He's not going to meet me.
Just for the chance, maybe.
Well, perhaps if it's open casket.
How long have y'all been dating?
Almost 2 years.
Why do you tell me that when you called? And why would you say I would be a fantasy date in that magazine?
What a rag.
You still are my fantasy date.
Why would you pick me? How old is your boyfriend?
25.
And you're 24?
Mm-hmm.
Where'd you meet?
In Arlington. Through friends.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Why are you smiling? How was it? Was there something weird there?
No. Not at all.
You've been dating how long?
Almost 2 years.
You sleeping with him?
I think that's a safe bet.
I'm talking to her.
I understand.
All right?
Yeah.
Using protection.
Of course.
All right. Otherwise, it's over.
This may be your best relationship yet.
Is he into sharing?
Oh, I don't know.
Why don't you go ask him? You guys ever done anything with other people?
No.
Yeah. Is he good looking?
Yes, very good looking.
Be bisexual.
Stop it. You're not.
Huh?
You would you do something to him to get to her?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm with you.
Even if I was the one behind pushing it in. At least I'd feel like I was still part of the process.
Be in the room.
What is it, Trey?
I think he got the visual.
Yeah. Well, at least I'm pushing one in, or it ain't mine, but I'm pushing it in.
By proxy?
Yeah.
I do have to say we have something in common.
You and me?
Mm-hmm. I'm a Grove rat.
What year did you graduate? High school?
02.
Huh?
02. I didn't go to Samuel, though.
Where you go?
Private school.
Yeah. Okay. Why are you laughing, Trey?
You didn't want to know what year she graduated high school.
He already knows my age.
Yeah, but I don't like any references. Chloe, what are you doing?
Take a picture?
Oh, is it all right? Because Dan said he's got calls. If we give out the URL for your MySpace, or would you rather not?
I don't care.
Okay.
She's beautiful, no doubt.
Can I
have a hug before you go?
Yeah.
All right.
I was hoping you'd ask.
Here comes the boyfriend through the wall like the Kool-Aid man.
Did you ever see the Kool-Aid man sketch when he got shot in the head on the other side?
Yeah. I saw the police had chalk outline of the Kool-Aid man.
Still has the smile.
Are you guys engaged?
No.
Has he asked?
No.
Well, he's a fool.
You're young. You give it some time. You date.
Do you feel like you're ready to get married?
No.
Do you live together?
Yes.
You're a whore. Russell, apologize to this woman.
She calls up. I'm her fantasy date. Well, I'm all worked up. I'm looking at the MySpace pictures. She's got cans the size of cans.
Some pictures just of the cans. That's, I'm not going to say the word, sexy.
There's been a lot of deception here.
Why? Are those your cans on the website?
Of the regular, just plain picture?
Yeah.
No, that's my friend.
You deceptive whore. You're still hot. Have you modeled?
No.
Yeah, you're too short.
Russ. Apologize to this woman.
No, she brought her boyfriend.
You called her short and a whore. Apologize.
I expected worse.
Oh, did you really?
Well, I thought you were going to.
Well, that can still happen.
Yeah, no. It's probably going to happen yet.
All right, give me a hug and go back with your boyfriend. Do you think that's going to last?
Sure.
What is it you like to do? Maybe we have more in common than you and he do. What do you like to go out and do?
Everything.
What was the last concert you went to?
I don't even remember.
What kind of music do you like?
Rock.
Classic, new?
Everything.
Yeah.
Both. Not a big fan of country.
See, I don't like country.
Oh, well, it's a bond.
This is just like eHarmony.
Do you drink?
Yes.
You drink whiskey?
Yes.
What's your favorite whiskey?
Well, I don't have too many. I haven't tried too many.
So you don't really have a favorite?
Crown. I mean,
I don't have a favorite either. They're all nasty. I don't know what else to ask.
You're a lech.
What does your boyfriend do for a living?
He works for Vought Aircraft. He's an airplane mechanic.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
How much does he make?
Don't anybody.
Man, I was going to have some type of bill there.
Sorry.
How much does he make?
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Trey, go ask him.
What is the difference?
And then while you're out there, be a good fella. What do you think he makes?
I really don't know. I have no clue.
50?
Maybe.
Where do you guys live? You live in a house or an apartment?
I have a condo.
Oh. How many square feet?
800.
800?
It's only a one bedroom.
I ain't making any cash.
He's probably making 50. AP mechanics make about 50, at least to start.
And you're okay with that?
Yeah.
An 800 square foot condo?
I have higher hopes in the future.
Well, you're not going to get it with him. You want somebody that's proven. But the house that I got, I can actually keep Amy and stick her on the other side.
Of your old palace?
Well, just pass her from time to time, away from the tram.
I don't believe she wants to be engaged to a man who would have another young lady come live with you.
I wouldn't either. It's time to go. All right, give me a hug and go on. Got all this burn built up.
Well, I don't want to hear about it. I don't. Nor you and Trey bumping things. Oh, my goodness.
Do what?
Can I get a picture?
A picture?
Yeah.
No!
Please. I'll make it my MySpace profile.
Russell?
What?
Don't.
I'm just hugging her.
I know better. And humping her.
Sometimes,
yes.
It's nice just to shut up.
Okay.
Why don't you pick that up as a hobby?
I'll start right now.
You got a camera? Where is it? Okay.
Can't miss this moment. Fantasy
day. Fantasy
day. Mm-hmm.
You always bring a boyfriend to a fantasy day? Why don't you check on the way out, see if he's bisexual.
I'll ask him. He's a big fan, so he may be.
Is he, like, slick, hot?
Yes.
Has he got any body hair?
Not much.
Oh, I can live with that.
Stop it. You're going to go gay just to get her.
Look at her.
I know. I see her. She's beautiful.
Okay. Where's the camp? Oh, there it is.
Oh, my Lord. All right.
Yes.
One, two, three.
Do I look fat?
No.
You look good?
But I got to look old.
Should we take another one? Just to be sure.
It's the grimace on your face. That...
I'm not happy about this. She shows up with her boyfriend, and she's missing about 300 cc's of breast that I was promised. Let me squat down, runt.
Okay, one.
Let me take my headphones off.
One, two, three.
She's got a flat little stomach.
Yeah.
All right, go on. By the way, thanks for lifting your shirt up and showing us earlier.
Thanks for letting me come in.
You're welcome.
Hopefully I'll see you again.
Yeah, well. No, they got something to argue about on the way home.
No doubt. Thanks to you. You just love it when people get arguing.
She brings her boyfriend.
She brought her boyfriend. He wanted to meet you.
And she's got pictures on MySpace.
That I don't understand. They weren't hers.
Well, some of them were hers, and I thought they were just... Chloe, what are you doing? Why are you smelling your headphones?
She was wearing them.
Oh.
Smell good.
What is it, Trey? Are you bisexual? Did you ask?
No.
Well, I can still see them in the... Oh, they're arguing.
They really?
Yeah.
I would be too.
Well, they tried to go out their front door because it's after 5:30. That door's locked.
Yeah.
So I watch him on the camera fussing. He's coming back by the door. Find out if he's queer.
You're not.
What is it, Brittany?
We're locked in.
Oh. Did you ask if he's bisexual? Go on. I'm not going to have somebody walk all over me.
I don't believe Amy would be okay with any of this.
Well, now it's time to dissolve this thing. What an absolute rip.
Why? She's beautiful. She came up, she jumped and ran up here to meet you.
And I got nothing out of it. And, again, she's missing a couple of cc's of breast.
Well, that's true. A look on his face, she might be single here pretty soon.
Now, that's his own fault.
Okay. All right. You keep talking.
Because you come up here, you even allow this to happen, you know what's going to happen up here. Period.
Did he look pissed?
He was none too happy.
Was he saying anything to her?
No. But I'll bet you they're having words right about now.
I'll give him about half a minute to get in the car.
He's a listener. What's the big shock as to what just happened? It was tame compared to what you were going to do.
I still don't think she asked him. I think either Trey or you, John, were right. He heard this going on. Went, there, you're not, no.
So he told me in the office.
Either A, you're not going, or I'm going with. Oh,
he told me that he heard it on the radio and said, wait till I get there, we'll go together. Because he's a listener.
Yeah.
But if you're a listener, you know what's going to happen.
Has it been a half minute?
Yeah.
Those are really pretty nipples.
Stop it. Why did you say that?
A little flat belly.
Yeah, I saw the belly.
Well, you saw that when her cans came out. And I like the way she did it in a coy fashion. All right, I'm going to show you. Don't say anything about it.
Russ, you want them to argue and break up?
Yes.
You've got somebody. She's got somebody.
I think listeners wanted me to have her. And now they're distraught, and it's going to reflect in the ratings, and it's going to be her fault. Trey, be a good fella and go shoot him in the parking lot.
Oh, my God.
How are we doing, Chloe?
Three.
Still fun. Still a great segment. She is precious.
Yeah. I really didn't expect her to be shaved down there.
Stop it.
Did that surprise you, Trey?
It is. Stop it. Are you be happy when they break up?
Yes.
She's still not going to come to you.
She might.
You're a fantasy date.
Okay.
That's at a distance. That's not something real.
No, a real fantasy date is if I pick somebody like Jennifer Aniston, where I've never got a shot at happening. She got a shot at this. She had a shot at it right when she was here. And now she's decided to let this go.
Call her loss.
We have time for news?
Oh,
started. Oh. Oh.
What?
Ow!
God!
I had fish.
What? You got a waft?
I'm sick of it.
Well, I don't want it over here.
I didn't hear what you said.
Break in a minute.
Oh, all right. Email or something instead of starting news?
Yeah.
Anyone?
Yeah, actually, I've got one that came in from something you were talking about earlier into the studio account. She says, Russ, I just love it when you show your immaturity and total lack of intelligence. I'm an older woman, 53. I've gone through menopause, and I don't look any different than when I did when I was 43. Women that look like men after menopause look like men before menopause. It had nothing to do with our hormones. Menopause has nothing to do with making women look like men grow up.
That's exactly what menopause is for. And, I don't know, she didn't already look like piss at 43.
Most of them don't look good after 40. That's a
you
really
go through,
tough age.
You go through menopause, and nature puts a little warning signs up. What's the matter?
I can't concentrate on anything because that fart. Holy man, has it got over you yet, Trey?
No.
Here it's coming.
You don't have any Lysol?
No, give me some Lysol.
No.
Then I'm putting Altoids in my nose. Thanks. Just spray it, Chuck. Also,
where was I?
Talking about menopause.
Oh, yeah. That's why nature puts out telltale signs on a chick who's gone through menopause. Men are supposed to reproduce. We're supposed to go out again as the bumblebees.
Yes.
And you go from flower to flower. If nature doesn't want us to pollinate a flower, they put hair on it. And that's what menopause is. You get whiskers, you get a mustache, and you look more like a man, so we're not attracted to you anymore. And as nature desires, mm-hmm. we don't waste our time banging you.
I mean, it does make sense. As Russ Martin-ish as it is, it does actually make sense.
It makes sense because that's the way that everything plays out.
I'm not sure that's actually why it happens.
Why else would at a certain point when women are no longer fertile, nature turns them into men?
Not really men. They just get hair because of the hormones.
Exactly.
Okay, well.
And that's a warning flag to us.
Stay away.
Don't eat this. It's gone bad.
Take it out of the fridge. Toss it.
Anything that grows hair on it. Food, women, you don't eat.
As well as they get, like I said earlier, they just get bitchy and mad.
And you're right. Age. Just another reason for us not to want to be around them. And that's probably not menopause. It's just the fact that they know that they've gone through menopause and now they no longer serve a purpose.
God. Yes, they do.
What is it?
Well, they can still live life and love.
You sound like you're talking about a paraplegia.
Well, in a way.
Okay, you can share the emails when they come out. What is it, Ann?
I would take line one real quick.
All right. Yes, Amanda.
Hi. I was just talking earlier about the whole girl coming up there with her boyfriend. And yeah.
Dan, what does she want?
She was telling me that if she were in this girl's position, she wouldn't hesitate to show you her boobs.
Well, this one did. And her clam.
Well, she didn't realize that because she couldn't hear all that.
Don't say that.
Because that was off the air.
Would you like to come up and let us look?
I would love to.
All right.
I wouldn't bring my boyfriend either.
How old are you? 21?
I'm 21, yeah.
Are you pretty?
I think I'm pretty.
Lady, I've been through enough turmoil today. Don't come up here and be a wolf.
Don't come up here what?
Do you have a picture you can send me before you come up? I don't want to get attached to you and then something happens.
I have a MySpace, and I've met you before. I was at the Russ Martin charity event that AHL Poker did.
Did you play?
No, I was one of the, I was working for AHL at the time.
Oh, hold on a second. Dan, get her MySpace so I can look at that. I can't, I.
You can't go through another one today.
Mentally, I can't have two breakups in one day.
Having two relationships in one day.
And I am that to me as soon as you can.
Does Amy not kill herself?
I don't know. I really don't. Break here.
Yes. All right.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show.
What is that, Trey?
Somebody left their sunglasses.
They left their what?
Sunglasses.
Let me see those.
Sniffing them.
Yeah, those are hers.
They smell good. She'll be back.
Ray-Ban. Ray-Ban make sunglasses like that?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. What do you think these run?
100, 110.
Well, then she got to come back.
That's actually... 200.
Do I? I don't care. I'm still talking. Load it again.
Don't even put those in your pants. Do not. Don't put them. Russ! Oh, my God. You are disgusting. Brittany, if you're listening, you don't need to class. Ah! I saw it. You stuck it right through the nose hole.
Yeah.
Lovely.
That's a hip penis. I bet it wears them at night. I will be back.
We'll be back to the Russ Martin Show. We don't even know what's going to come out of his mouth next. Ross Martin. To the Russ Martin Show.
Traffic. Hi, Gail.
Howdy.
What do we got?
Well, two wrecks in Fort Worth on northbound 820, one at Brentwood Stair and the other at Barry. And the rest of the slow traffic is just simply because. In Dallas, it's heavy on 30 East Darrell Thornton between downtown and Jim Miller. Eastbound LBJ still heavy from around the High 5 out toward Garland. And westbound LBJ is just crawling from Central to 35. It's just slow and heavy stuff. So enjoy the show and not the traffic. I'm Gail Lightfoot on the Russ Martin Show.
All right, thanks, Gail. 29 for the Oregon low back into the 50s. Tomorrow is 51 now at Live 105.3.
All right, Dan, you ready to go?
Yes.
Speaking of Dan, I have an email.
Hang on. You tell that chick that wanted me to show her cans, it's fine for her to come up.
Okay.
All right. What is it?
Somebody said they missed Dan singing at the House of Blues, but heard it on the air. It was hilarious. Is he going to do it again at the White Trash Party?
Dan, you never answered that email. Are you in for the White Trash in March?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll be happy to do that song.
What?
What?
Call the, what's her name? About her glasses.
What's her face?
Huh?
The chick was just in here. She left her glasses. Why don't you call her and see if she wants to come back up?
Well, now that clip's funny to me, and I didn't get it the first time you guys sent it to me.
No, it's not playing.
She was staying up from the time she left the club to get her flower delivery in the morning.
Huh? Really, out of in or out of context? It wasn't funny to me, but now it is.
It is funny.
She was staying up from the time she left the club to get her flower delivery in the morning.
Huh? All right, let's back up. What are you trying to tell me?
The chick that was just in here, I don't remember
her
name.
Do you
want this? No.
Sure?
Positive.
Okay.
That she left her sunglasses.
Paper bin.
Yeah.
Ready to call her and see if she wants to come back up and get her sunglasses.
Oh. Dan, did you ever get her cell or did she just call you?
No, I got her cell at one point, yeah.
Can you IM it to me?
Sure.
Thank you.
From the time she left the club to get her flower delivery in the morning?
Huh? Are these sunglasses she left? Do you really think a couple $100?
Oh, yeah.
If they're Ray-Bans, yeah. I mean, I have some Ray-Bans, and they were a couple $100.
I never spend more than $3 or $4 on anything.
I don't either. They were a gift.
Well, you lose them, you set on them, you don't care.
Yeah, but people that want to wear nice stuff do care. It's like nice watches. You don't care. You
know, I wouldn't know if either. These are expensive or not. Mm-hmm.
Chicks do.
All right, there's her cell.
Hello?
I forgot her name.
Brittany.
Thank you. I like to move on.
Say your tell your traumatized.
Yeah. Hello.
Brittany.
Yes.
It's Russ.
Hi, Russ.
You left your sunglasses up here.
Who's that?
Did I? Oh.
What?
It's us. I left my sunglasses up there.
Yeah. You can
because I left them up there.
You want to come back and get them?
Yeah.
You
I'll come back and get them.
Not now.
Let's take them off.
I can't come. Well, when do you want me to come back?
Oh, we can meet for lunch. I'll give them to you.
No.
No, it's probably not a good idea. I'll shove and cut my head off.
Why'd you take them off? Why do you need to have eyes?
If she calls back, I'll hang on to them for a while.
Maybe we should mail them to her. Yes. Why did you just join this? This poor guy, tortured by you.
Why'd you take him off?
You don't know him. I understand why you torture me. You feel some joy there. I get that.
Well, she deserves something.
What does she deserve?
She lied to me about having a boyfriend.
She didn't lie. She wasn't clear.
I got an email. Shut up. Yeah, with the Bank of America. Yeah, I don't care. Keep it. She lied about having a boyfriend. She shows up. She also didn't have implants like it looked like on her MySpace picture.
It's one of her friends. That should be labeled as one of her friends.
Yeah, because it looks just like her.
Mm-hmm. Whore. Quit calling her whore. There's no reason to call people names.
Huh?
Very nice.
Hey. Did you have something else, Trey? You're holding something.
Kind of a different subject, but...
All right, what is it?
Email came in.
What was that? leaning over to him and making a monster.
I was just trying to distract him to see if he would stutter. His listeners don't know I'm doing this around him.
I don't think you'll have to distract him.
Chuck might pee his pants.
Why? Just because I went over and poked at him?
Yeah.
I don't believe I get the show.
I missed it. I was on the stupid phone again.
I told you to tell you that. You want to see what they're laughing at?
Yes.
Okay. And then you tell me if you get it. Because I don't.
All right.
All right. Trey is bringing up an email.
Got an email?
All right, go ahead.
Russ.
Now, do you get that?
Well, now, granted, your face is behind your computer screen, so maybe I'm missing part of it.
I don't think that
Do to me exactly what you did to Trey so I don't miss anything.
All right. Go ahead, Trey.
Russ.
All right, yeah.
I don't like being on the outside of a joke.
You're not on the outside of the joke.
He's reading the email, and I'm trying to get him. I'm trying to get him to stutter. Obviously, the listeners don't know I'm doing it, so it would just go along with a bit.
Yeah. Well.
But then you have everybody else who can't keep things to themselves.
Maybe if I do it to you, you'll see the humor.
All right. Go ahead.
What? See? It's because you were doing it, you didn't see the humor.
Well, but Chuck's behind me. What's he laughing at?
He saw you. Dude, he didn't see your face, but he saw that.
It's also Trey's face, too.
Well, yeah, Trey jumped because Trey thought. All right, hell, I've missed a cue on something. What's he telling me? I can't figure this one out. A lot of times, while somebody else is doing something, I'll give hand cues, go get this, pick this up, right. Hand me that.
Oh, my God.
Let me do it straight to Chuck, see if he laughs again.
Okay. That's funny from every angle.
I don't get it. I mean, if I did, I'd keep doing it, but I don't get it.
It's just scary funny. You said grown man with the big monster face going, ah.
All right.
Go home and do it in front of your mirror tonight.
You gotta read the email?
Sure.
My favorite part of that was, I don't get this show.
Well, you know, you flip on some morning show, they're all laughing at something.
Uh-huh.
Even though you heard the entire bit, you don't get it. What are they laughing at? God. That's where I am right now.
Okay. It was funny.
God, I'd listened to Craddock this morning.
Good God. What were they talking about?
He was doing some bit with a microphone like you have down there.
The karaoke?
Except
or the voice changer?
The voice changer, but the high voice.
All right.
Calling some hotel. And it was just, it was the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. I don't get.
What was he calling the hotel about? As he started the bit, did he tell them they were on the air?
No, I don't think so.
Well, then it was fake.
Yeah, most of his stuff is. Most of the pranks he pulls on the phone.
That makes it even worse.
Are fake.
Why, that it was planned?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Because he did the burn your buns things for years.
Yeah,
with Eagle.
You can't put them on the air. Unless they call in. If they call in, then it's all fair game. You call out, you got to tell somebody they're on the air. You can't do anything. You can't even tape it ahead of time. So, it was just a bit that went bad?
I thought it blew.
Oh.
But
so, certainly not something as compelling as this.
No.
The hands in the face. What, Dan?
Can we get video of that?
No.
People want to see that.
What are you going to make it, a screensaver?
Yes.
Hey, your computer's still on.
That, and I want to get a screen capture of the video and make that into a t-shirt. Or one of our new billboards.
What if we could do that? Do some type of screensaver? Uh-huh. I could do this, videotape it on the other side of the glass, and I'm just licking the window.
Yeah. Do that. Yeah.
Looks like somebody's kidding me.
All right. Okay. Enough.
All right. What's the email?
Okay.
Do we have time for this?
Yes.
Oh, my God. All right, go ahead.
Russ, my wife has put on some weight recently, and I don't know how to tell her that it bothers me. What would you do if Amy gained 20 pounds?
I'd stay in touch.
She put on a little bit of weight.
She gained 20 pounds. There's something going on, and I'm going somebody fart?
Yeah, I think you did.
Oh. Okay. Oh, Jesus. She gains 20 pounds. Yeah, that's it.
You break up with someone you love over 20 pounds. How about you say
20 pounds.
Okay, how about you say
she only weighs 100, so you tack on 20 to her. That's a lot of weight, percentage-wise.
Okay, so you just say, hey, let's go to the gym together. Let's work out.
No.
Why?
I go to the gym on my own every day. I don't have anybody prod me to go. You want to sit around, be complacent, and become comfortable in a relationship and get fat. That's why guys normally cheat.
Okay. You've said before if she had some kind of birth defect, you'd kick her to the curb, too. So this really
especially if it was something she hid from me and I didn't know until the first time I got her naked.
This shouldn't surprise me too much. If something drastic happened like that, bye. Just see you. You're fat. You're fat. Bye.
Yeah.
What if you're married?
Then it's, you're fat, I want a divorce.
I can't think in those terms. The married part.
You better.
I can't. It gives me this face. And if she's gained 20 pounds, there's something else that's going on. Probably psychological, and I don't have time to deal with that.
Yeah. I just think it's kind of superficial, but I understand. I mean, you've said before.
So if Joy gained 20 pounds, you wouldn't have a problem.
I would definitely talk to her about it. I mean,
And how would you address it?
I've gained weight. I'm not sure how I address it, really. I don't think I'd have to. She's so weird.
That's not what we're talking about.
How would I address it?
Yeah.
Again, I don't know. I can't think in those terms because.
Possibly in song.
No, I wouldn't do it in song. It wouldn't be rude. It wouldn't be ugly to the person I love.
How about some pictures?
No.
A little pictogram?
No.
A little picture of Joy with four stomachs?
No. I wouldn't do that to her. She'd know it. You know it.
That doesn't answer the question. If she gained 20 pounds, you'd do what?
I'd probably at some point, about 10 pounds in, go.
How are you going to address that? Chicks don't like to talk about their weight.
You know,
they're as wiggy about it as I am. Somebody brings up my weight, I'm going to have a fit. If Amy were to come in and say something to me like, you know what, too much drinking at night, you got a gut, why don't we do more cardio? Okay. Yeah. Well, why don't you run in front of the trunk?
You get yours out of the way first.
Did that answer the question?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, that would be it.
That would be the end of it.
And if she pops some birth defect on me that I didn't know about, I need to know that as well.
Six toes.
Or the nipple out of the baby tooth grown out of the nipple.
There's no one ever had a baby tooth grow out of their nipple.
That's why it's called a birth defect.
People
don't ask for those. They don't go to the kiosk at the mall and decide to have a baby tooth put in. Fool. All right. Ready for news, Dan? Do we have time, Flo? Okay. All right, 627, Dan O'Malley's here with news.
Thank you, Russ. Roy City High School officials banned the airing of a student-produced public service announcement because it features two girls almost kissing. The conflict between the student producer and school officials began after a high school journalism and media contest last week in California. Judges there asked seniors Mackenzie Maxwell and Carrie Zimlich to produce a 30-second public service announcement about honesty. The judges encouraged the contestants to be creative, unconventional, and to take risks.
Is this about gays coming out?
Yes.
All right.
So Mackenzie, who witnessed her mom's former struggles with being honest about her homosexuality, she decided to film a segment about a teenage girl suffering through a similar battle. In the video, a teenage girl stands between two paths. One is labeled lies and the other is labeled truth. After choosing the lies path, the girl is shown unhappy and uncomfortable with a male companion. But when she chooses the other, the music is upbeat, the girl's relaxed and content with her female partner. When the partners sit on a bench,
they're not going to let kids address homosexuality in a school environment.
Well, they told them to be cutting edge and to have a message. And the girls don't actually kiss. It's one, like, a second and a half of them leaning in to each other.
Now, obviously, it's commonplace on television, but the school, still, they let them put that out. You're going to have more of an issue with the parents. And so forget about being avant-garde.
I don't think so. I totally think it's not like it's an issue that we don't deal with every day throughout our lives.
But they're still not going to let kids address that in a school environment.
They told them specifically.
They don't like to have sex ed in school.
Well, that's true.
So you want to address lesbianism? And I go this round. What if it's two guys leaning in?
Oh.
Same issue. Everything's done as artistically as that one was done.
I saw it. It's very artistic. It's very well done.
And if you get two guys and one of them leans in and does.
That.
Is it still going to be something you want to see?
Yeah. It still would be, as long as I understand the premise of it and what it's trying to teach. It's a public service announcement to teach you about.
There are different ways to deal with things that you keep to yourself or internal struggles. Doesn't have to be about sexuality.
They just ask them to do something creative and new and different, and they did.
Okay, how's the story end? Dan.
Principal Tony Gaunt decided to ban the video from Roy City High School Television Network, RCTV. Joel Nell Melody, a community relations director for the district, said there was an inappropriate clip in it, and they told her if she took that piece of the PSA out, they would run it.
Well, then I was wrong on that. They would still allow them to. Do they ever say homosexuality, or they just talk about internal struggles?
Internal struggles.
And then at the end, you have two chicks coming together, and you realize what the story was about, or is it obvious?
No, yeah, it's obvious, because in here what I said was the focal person is standing in front of two paths. She goes down the path of lies, which is her looking miserable with a guy. Then she goes back and takes the other path, and it's her very happy, upbeat music, and leaning in towards kissing another woman. But they don't actually touch.
No. Okay. So they took out that second and a half of them leaning in. They let them air it.
Well, if you take the two chicks kissing out, you don't really know what that other path was going to be. You're standing there unhappy with a guy. It could mean, I'm unhappy in this relationship. Go try another one, because there's no reason to stay with this one guy. I mean, you don't really know that it's about sexuality.
They show them hugging, the two girls hugging on a park bench and leaning into each other, and they're all happy now. Did that?
Oh.
No. Too crap. The girls are cute, too.
How old are they, Dan?
I think they were 18.
Thank you.
All right.
18.
How are you doing, Chloe?
Breaking three.
Good, Dan.
Okay. The 30-year-old girlfriend of Zephyr Cove, resident Max Baer Jr., an entrepreneur and actor best known for his role as Jethro in the 1960s sitcom The Beverly Hills, died of an apparent self-inflicted gunshot wound over the weekend.
Who died?
Max Baer Jr.'s
girlfriend. She shot herself.
Yeah, I would too.
Why? Russ Martin.
You want to talk to him on the phone?
Yes.
Obviously. Was she living with him?
Apparently so.
Yes.
You can't hang up on him.
About 1:15 on Thursday, Douglas County Sheriff's deputies and Tahoe Douglas paramedics responded to a report of an attempted suicide at Bear's Zephyr Heights residence. Bear led deputies to a bedroom of the home where they found the woman suffering from a single gunshot wound to the chest from a semi-automatic handgun. She was still conscious when officers arrived and told the deputies that the incident was an attempted suicide on her part. The gun was recovered from the scene, and the case is being investigated as a suicide.
Did they say that she had had a history of that? Anything that had led up to it?
No.
None of that's come out yet.
No.
A note?
There was a suicide note, yes. And she didn't, and she was conscious enough to tell the officers, I did this. And then she died.
Oh. Well, that's a good sport.
Quite sure he had nothing to do with it.
Well, I'm sure he didn't. But anytime something like that happens, you're an immediate suspect.
Oh, yeah, you got
to
know.
And just the fact that she happened to live through it and be able to say, I did this, and there was other evidence to corroborate that.
Yeah. Otherwise, he would be in trouble.
The Dodge County, Wisconsin Sheriff's Department, we have some audio with this, by the way.
Okay.
Has released a recording of a 911 call that they got early on Sunday from a woman who was calling from her truck to complain.
What cut?
18.
Do I have the disc?
Yep, the one that says news.
Yeah, let me see. That ain't it. Right here?
That's it.
All right. Go ahead.
Recording of a 911 call they got early on Sunday from a woman who was calling from her truck to complain that her boyfriend said she was too drunk to drive.
What cut?
18.
Goddamn.
The woman is 51-year-old Patricia Dykstra of Fox Lane, Wisconsin. Around 12:29 a.m. on Sunday, she called 911 from her cell phone and then hung up. The dispatcher called her back.
That's where this picks up.
We just got a 911 call from your cell phone.
Yes. I tried also to follow me home because somebody seems to think I can't drive home straight.
Okay, why is that?
Oh, you seem to think I'm too intoxicated to drive.
Okay, and so...
What state is this? Obviously, it's up north.
Yeah, it's Wisconsin.
Oh, yeah.
Come follow me home. That's what they're going to do.
Yes. I tried also to follow me home because somebody seems to think I can't drive home straight.
Oh, for sure.
Okay, why is that?
Oh, you seem to think I'm too intoxicated to drive.
Okay, and so you called 911 or he called 911?
Well, he wanted me to call 911 because he thinks I'm too drunk to drive.
And he's riding in the car with you?
Yes, he is.
Okay.
What the heck do you mean?
You're driving now or where?
Yes, I am.
Can I talk to him?
Sure.
Do they catch them?
Oh, yes.
Is that on the tape?
Not the catch, no. You want the whole story, how they catch them?
Yeah.
She gives the 911 operator the car, the description, where they live, where they're going, and where they are.
So, whether they catch them or not, all they got to do is go to the house and wait on them.
That's all they did. They drove to the house and waited for her to pull up.
To where she admitted to drinking a six-pack of beer and hopping in the truck.
She had a .1. She blew a .14.
He says he doesn't know anybody.
Okay, so he's riding with you and he called 911 because he thinks you're too intoxicated to drive.
Yeah, but he ain't going to talk to nobody.
Okay, but you're still driving. Have you had too much to drink tonight?
Huh?
Have you had too much to drink tonight that you shouldn't be driving?
I don't think so, ma'am.
Okay, and you're almost home, you said?
Yes, I am.
So where do you live at?
Fox Lake.
Okay, where are you now?
It's about the corner of C&P.
Okay. What kind of vehicle are you in?
Pickup truck, 2002, tan.
What's your name, ma'am?
Pat Dykstra.
Pat? Okay. Well, I can...
They're going to have the paperwork ready when she gets home.
Yeah, that's already filled out. Now, she was on CNN yesterday going, I don't think I should have gotten a ticket because apparently she beat the cops home by a few, either a minute or half a minute.
Yeah, you can't prove that she was well, you can go back and track the GPS on the phone. So, yeah, in essence, they can't prove she was behind the wheel.
No, she already admitted
maybe she could run 50 miles an hour.
She already admitted it. Here's where I am. I'm over here, and I'm going home.
Well, you're going to have to have some proof. Yeah, what are you laughing at?
Just the visual of her running 50 miles per hour. If you've seen this woman, you'd be laughing as hard as I am. I know they have moose in Wisconsin.
The point is, they go back, they can check the GPS, they can tell that she wasn't at the house.
Right.
they probably could also tell the speed of the GPS signal, so you'd have to say that I was on foot there.
Well, I don't think her lawyers will even challenge this.
I think you can if I'm already home.
That was what she was saying on CNN. I was at home when they gave me the ticket there.
Yeah.
If they can't, I thought if they can't put you behind the wheel.
Yeah, I think that becomes a little iffy, regardless of what you told them.
It'll probably go to court, but we'll see. It's just funny.
Certainly let you go, Pat. I don't want to cause you to...
I would appreciate that,
because
I don't like driving on the phone.
Yeah.
She wants to be safe. She doesn't want to drive while I'm talking on the phone.
It's very distracting, Dad.
Especially when you're plowed.
It's hard to do all these things.
What the heck do you mean?
Why didn't the dispatch tell her to pull over?
That's what she should have done. It's just say
that's
stop
gonna,
right that, there.
That's going to come back and become an issue. Because you're already suspected of DWI, and the dispatch says... You drive safely.
Continue driving. Just do it safe.
Is that about the end of this?
Yeah.
So, Pat, drive carefully, okay?
No problem.
All right. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
So she only got a ticket. They even take her in, but she's fighting it.
I don't... And the ticket's going to be for what?
DUI.
Normally, you don't get a ticket for DUI. They haul your ass in.
I guess because she was already home. They didn't haul her in.
Well, you get credit for that.
Again, you have to find out when this thing goes to court, which way it's going to go.
Well, the burden of proof is going to be, was she too intoxicated to operate a motor vehicle? She made it home. She was able to talk to a dispatch, do all of those things, still make it to the house.
She blew a .14, like I said.
So. Well, you don't know that she didn't enjoy something when she got home.
You're a good lawyer. You're right. All those things will come out. I went home. I grabbed...
But if you're stupid enough to call the cops to follow you home, well, my boyfriend doesn't know anybody. Call our buddy the cops.
You lived ahead. That conversation was going on in the car. I'm going to call 911 on you. Hell, I'll do it myself. Brilliant.
Take it away out of your sailor. You break here? All right.
Russ Martin Show. Like nothing you've ever heard before. The Russ Martin Show. Now, back to the Russ Martin Show.
Jesse from Jackal said it. Because I told him I don't think we can afford the entire band.
Yeah, just him.
For the white trash party. Find out what it's going to cost to fly him out, what he charged to come out, learn a couple of the Jackal songs.
That'd be such a party.
Well, how hard is the, was it the Lumberjack?
Lumberjack is extremely easy. The only issue that I think we would have, not even really an issue, is just tuning up his chainsaw.
I don't think that's going to be an issue.
Yeah. That's the only thing I think that would be a pain to do. Besides that, the song's easy. It's just a boogie riff. You could do that real easy.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
The more we learn about rock and roll, the more it seems like it's all pretty simple. Am I wrong? Why does it sound so complicated?
I think that's why they throw in guitar solos. Because the structure is pretty much basic. Then the guy's got to show off in the middle of the song.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and sometimes they just
every time we bring a song up, it's like, oh, that one's easy. Yeah, that's easy. That's only three chords. That's only two chords. That's a half a chord.
Sometimes they layer it. So that's what makes it sound more difficult. They layer it in the studio to where it sounds like there's a bunch of stuff going on. In reality, just two different guitars and one guitar doing a very basic thing that...
That's the rhythm guitar.
Yeah.
That's me.
Is that what you play?
Okay. The easy stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Now, what key is the Jackal thing in?
I think A or E.
Find a bumper.
Is that the one that just goes dun 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 dun?
Yeah.
Okay.
Where is it?
17. 6.
Yeah, it's a boogie riff. And it'll go up a notch in a second. Coming up, but you don't need that.
Now, back to the Russ Martin Show.
Actually, it stays on the same riff. What key is that shot?
A sharp.
Where would it go after A sharp?
A sharp.
And then back to A?
Yeah.
And then where?
Yeah.
I don't know where F is.
I bet you do.
No, you can figure this out really easily.
So far ahead.
Is this 10?
Yes.
A sharp?
Yep.
Is that it?
That's it.
And then
you do have it.
Back to A sharp. And then where?
F.
All right, we got that one.
Okay. Yeah, it's almost everything. It seems like everything comes up. You're like, it's easy. You pick it up and you have it.
Well, no, you're right. It's
Bowling for Soup yesterday. You just, boom.
Well, the Bowling for Soup is just power chords.
1985.
Isn't that it?
Yep, pretty much.
What are you waving at, Gavin?
Yeah, let's jam it, man.
The Jackal?
No.
Can we?
Do 1985.
With Jarrett.
Oh.
He's saying,
if he can make it, great, but I mean, if he can't.
Well, hang on, John. You talked to him after the show.
I did talk to him after the show. Right. Yeah.
He said he would try and make it for the 14th.
Trying to make it for 14th. March. Correct.
Did he say he was going to charge us?
He did not say. I'm sure he won't. I'm speaking out of my rear. I shouldn't say that.
What's just one song?
What's one song? He's a huge. They are huge fans of the show.
And how much airtime has that the 1985 song got?
Quite a bit, actually.
All right. Probably show up on some Billboard charts now.
He played it 5 times.
And then Chuck and I are going through the song last night, okay, so I can get part of it down. Gavin comes flying in.
What's the saying?
Hey, if Jarrett bails, I'm all over this.
You should be happy about that.
Gavin, it's not a song. I like the song, but it's not a song I would normally add to the band set list if the lead singer wasn't going to be there.
He's trying to be a helpful partner.
You got other stuff to work on. You got your Elton John stuff. You got whatever else. Time Warp. Blah, blah.
I know. Trying to help. Let's jam it. Let's try it.
I don't have it down yet.
Oh, is there some kind of version we can pull up or something?
No.
We have it in here.
No.
We do.
No.
You had it last night.
Mm-mm.
You were playing it.
I was playing it.
You had it in the...
it's in the Jack FM studio, but it's got the vocals in it.
Oh, okay. Well, you can sing along with the vocals.
Yeah.
Okay.
Maybe after 7 o'clock, then Lycus can eat it.
Okay.
Let Arbitron slap him around. We'll do it at the end of the show. Do you know the words?
I'll pull the lyrics.
You don't even have the song down?
No!
Why did you come in the studio saying, I'm all over this, if Jarrett from Bowling for Soup can't make it?
Because then at that point, you grab the lyrics and you start memorizing the lyrics.
It made it sound like you already had it down. It was one of your favorites.
Joy does.
I like the song.
Why don't we just let Joy do it?
Do we need to get that audio out again? No, she can't sing. Love her to death. That's one thing she doesn't do well. She likes to do it. She just doesn't.
I think it's a great idea.
I like Joy.
I love Joy, but she's not going to sing in the band.
I think she can sing.
Did you hear the same audio I heard in my headphones?
Yes.
You think that's good singing?
Well, the best part is I want her in the band and you don't, and that's going to create turmoil.
I don't want her in the band. No, no backstage antics. No, no.
Dan, do we have any more news to take us up to 7, and then Gavin can ruin Lycus' first few minutes? Go ahead.
I'm singing. I also have Tony. It's really bad audio, so you're not going to want to play a lot of it, but cut to 20. It's Tony Romo and Jessica Simpson singing. You know, with a band and out in L.A.
Which band?
Metal School.
That's the same band that Gavin's been pushing on me. Isn't that right, Gavin?
Yeah, I like them. They're a good band.
Why was it that was a big one you were pushing? You sent me a link to that about 3 weeks ago and kept checking every few days. Did you listen to it?
Yeah, because, I mean, I think they're a good sounding band.
They were too much. we're trying to keep the price down, so we go back to the original concept of the white trash party. It's only a few dollars.
I understand that. I'm just trying to pitch.
And you were talking about paying them. We were going to close, right? The RMS band?
Yes.
And you were going to pay them more than me?
Yeah, usually we play our national acts more, yeah.
But normally they would headline.
Well, no, they said they'll play wherever.
Why don't you go ahead and book them, and we'll let them headline.
Oh.
Yeah.
No, we always finish with you. We decided that after the last two shows when people left.
And everybody walked out.
So what is your thing? Do you think Romo's going to show up because we've got the metal school?
If we have metal school and he's in town, absolutely.
He's apparently a very, very big fan.
All right. Well, what cut is it?
It's, again, I press it.
What cut is it?
20. It's really bad audio from somebody's cell phone, I think.
Well, let me ask this. What song is that?
I can't even tell. All I know is I saw...
Journey. What is it?
It's Journey.
How can you tell?
I just... You tell?
I don't like them. They're too distorted. Good. What?
The only way they get him up on stage is they get the whole audience to go, pussy, pussy, call him a pussy, and he finally drug him in his
Maybe ass. They were trying to get Jessica up there.
No. She was up there, too. You can tell. He was really getting into it. I mean, he was pulling a Gavin, you know, with a microphone all the way back, and she's looking at him right in the eyes like, stop this now.
Honey, I was the one they were calling for early.
Seriously. And he can't sing at all, and he's just jamming into it, doing the whole rock thing, and she's staring at him in the eye.
Didn't Romo do this before?
Yes, he did. Yes, there was another video floating around of him singing.
Gavin, was that the same band?
Yes.
Yes.
So, does he just travel around, or anytime metal school's in town, that's where he's gone? Going?
Yeah, they've only been here once, but he must have been out in L.A.
It was.
Yeah, and then the previous time, he saw him out in L.A., too.
All right. Chloe, have you ever heard him?
Not really.
All right. Do you have a diss for him, Gavin? Is it too late to book him?
No,
Gavin.
I don't want to book him if you don't want him.
I'm just asking you questions. Would you do me a favor and answer in a timely fashion?
I gave Chloe a mini disc. There should be a mini disc in there.
All right, why didn't you tell me that when I said, do you have a disc, instead of sitting there like a turd?
God.
Hello?
Yes, there's a mini disc in there. I don't know.
I've already asked you that. Where is it?
I don't know. I gave it to Chloe like 2 weeks ago. I'm not in charge of mini discs.
Okay. Is this it?
Yes.
We found it. Thank you.
Jesus.
You just love tormenting him.
It's he's sitting there. Do you have a disc?
It's in there.
Oh. Just tell me yes or no. He's been doing this all week. I don't know if he's sick. I don't know if it's the fact that I'm on testosterone.
It's partly that.
I don't think it's mostly me.
No, in this case.
He just says, I'll ask him something.
He's been sick.
He'll sit there.
He's been sick. So he said.
Well, then don't come to work.
Fine.
Why do you show up if you're not going to be of any use? Today, you've been absolutely useless.
You are so ridiculous.
Leave me alone. How many cuts are on this, Chloe?
Two.
Am I going to know the songs?
Nope.
Okay.
Thank you. There. Give that back to Gavin. Go ahead, Dan.
A man was charged with drunken driving after going through... Actually, this is one of those times where I can replace man with monkey and it would make the story better.
We need a little push at the end of the show here.
Okay. A monkey has been charged with drunken driving after going through two bottles of wine, cutting through a snowstorm on his lawnmower, and riding down the center of the street to reach yet another liquor store.
Why would a monkey have a house?
I love that you're focused on the house when he's drunk riding a lawnmower.
Well, that means he has a house and a lawn.
Yeah. He's obviously done quite well for himself.
All right, everybody.
An uptown monkey?
There have been sightings.
Go ahead.
Police found Frank the monkey homeward bound on his John Deere Saturday night, toting four bottles of wine in a paper bag.
Where'd he get the cash?
Home equity? I don't know.
Your dog had cash in its mouth. Maybe the monkey did. Got it from a dog.
I don't know. That was stupid. The monkey told officers that his monkey wife had taken their car to work and that the mower was the only way the monkey could reach the store, which was 2 miles from home.
A very logical monkey.
Yeah. Well, the monkey's blood alcohol was 2.5 times Michigan's legal driving limit of 0.08.
How did they decide what it was for monkeys? You know I was going to have these questions. You're the idiot that turned the story around.
It's the monkey breath test.
I sure wish it was 7. Let's just sit here and wait.
No, don't.
Count down the seconds.
You can have Gavin sing.
Gavin, do you want to go through this song?
Sure, if you want to, let's go.
Are you? Can you? What do you got? Do you have allergies?
I'm fine. I don't know why you hate me, but I'm fine.
I'm just talking about if you're sick, you're not going to be able to sing on key, i.e. band practice this past Saturday.
Yeah, I know. It's a big concern. I haven't got my voice back since the last time I was sick. My voice is back, but I can't hit high notes.
Okay. Is this a karaoke version?
Yes.
All right, come on, Gavin. Chuck, you'll be ready to go, yes?
Yes.
Not for Gavin. I meant to get out of here. And you ready with the plugs, Dan?
Right here.
Okay. We started off so good.
It's been a fun show.
Until about 6:15, things were smoking along.
It's been great.
Yeah, it's been a slow half hour. Be a good fella and shoot Gavin in the head.
Can I borrow your gun?
You came unprepared.
Sorry.
Once again.
All right. Let me load this.
Wall. She never had it all. One Prozac a day. Husband's a CPA. Her dreams went out the door when she turned 24. Only been with one man. What happened to her plan? She was gonna be an actress. She was gonna be a star. She was gonna shake her ass on the hood of Whitesnake's car. Her yellow SUV is now the enemy. Look at her average life, and nothing has been alright. Bruce with Madonna, way before Nirvana. There was YouTube and Blondie, and music still on MTV. Her two kids in high school, they tell her that she's uncool, cause she's still preoccupied. 1985.
Sounds pretty close.
Wasn't bad at all, really. Especially if you'd done his full voice back.
Yeah, it needs work.
All right, you can do it.
Cool. Just tell me when. I'll do it.
March 14th. Goodbye.
Well, I know that. I'm just saying. Give me the official cue, and I'll do it.
All right.
I'll start learning it.
Okay, go ahead.
Start practicing.
Thank you.
Fine. Did you take home the single-serving coughing pods that we had?
What?
Well, I'm on the microphone. The single serving coffee pods that you were talking about yesterday that you guys were so excited about that now are missing.
I didn't know we had any.
So it's just a coincidence they were talked about on the show and now they're gone?
How many are missing?
I don't know. I just got an email from Jennifer Petty.
That said what? Because I only took 7 or 8. How many are missing?
I guess that amount. She didn't give an exact amount.
Why would you miss 7 or 8?
I don't know. She just said she got an email.
Well, if it's more than that, then Dan took the rest of them.
I told Dan not to take them.
It might have been just a little too quick, but I'm still all right. I only took a few.
All right. You should ask.
Why do I got to ask?
Because I'll get them for you.
They were on the way out. And then Dan took the rest of them.
Do you take toilet paper? Do you take paper towel? What
you
else?
You gonna cover up his punchline?
No.
Frank, be a good guy and shoot him.
Okay.
I told me not to take him.
Thanks. Yeah. I sure would like to end on an up note.
We shot Chloe.
I think that's worn out. Isn't it?
I don't think so. I'll bet it never gets old.
All right, hook him up.
That's worn out.
What were you trying to talk to me about during the break about some chick that you dated said I screwed her?
No, you tried to. Yeah, I don't trust you. You come over when I was out of town, you come over to
Hang
her
on.
Apartment.
How long ago was this?
I, probably 8 years ago, at least.
Which chick was this?
The chick lived in Arlington, Amy.
I was banging her roommate. That was the one that I took the bottle of Flex shampoo and shoved it in her clam.
Yeah, but I don't think her roommate was home at the time.
Yeah, she was. Why else would I be over there?
Amy said something about you cornering her on the patio.
And doing what? I only had one bottle of Flex.
It wasn't
double-headed.
I don't remember. Just you trying to get...
How long have you been sitting on... Have you told me about this before?
Yeah, one time. We brought it up one time before.
And didn't we address it?
Yeah, you said you were...
Ow! Sorry. I'm sorry, what? I said what?
You said you were... You said you were banging the roommate. I don't think the roommate was there that night.
She was always there when I came over. I had no reason to come over if just Amy was there.
Okay.
Is that thing not working?
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead, Chuck. Dan?
For more information about the Russ Martin Show, including pictures, videos, and more, go to RussMartin.com. To answer any question you may have about the show, go to RussMartin.info. To instant email the show and only during the show, send that to studio@RussMartin.com. Other show websites, JohnDavidRyan.com, DanAnnTassos.com, DJClo.com, TreyTrenholm.com, and for Chuck on the keyboards, ChuckWheat.com. The official caterer of the Russ Martin Show is Sugar Babies Barbecue. Their website, Sugar Babies.
Hold on. Close eyes.
I dropped it.
Trey, plug that in, will you? Dan.
The official limo service of the Russ Martin Show is done by Limo George. His website, limogeorge.com. Russ gets his guitars and band equipment from the Guitar Center. Their website, guitarcenter.com. The official liquor store of the Russ Martin Show is Majestic Fine Wine and Spirits.
How high is that, Trey?
It was on 8.
How high is it go?
8.
Oh, put it back.
Okay. MajesticLiquors.com and the official site for Live 105.3 is Live 105.3.com.
Wait. Hold up late on the counter again.
Now, listen to the Russ Martin Show anytime you want on the web at RussMartin.info.